Seriously, man, never expected Chiaki to have such huge jugs. Soda? Dude.
What happened?
Jugs. Okay, I see what you're talking about, but... Chiaki, why are you just standing there like that in front of me with those things? Welcome, Kumas, to another episode of Danganronpa! You're here with Kuma! It's been a while since I've played last time. I'm super excited. I don't actually remember 100% where we left off, but I don't give a crap. I'm gonna binge as much as I can, because episode 8 of the Despair arc was just released, and I know it's only a 12 episode season, so I gotta finish Danganronpa 2 as quick as I can, which means I gotta play like hell. I gotta binge this shit like I'm addicted, which I am. This is my heroine. This game is becoming my heroine. So for you guys that are watching on YouTube, I know this is probably going to be released months after I play it, but please understand I had to play in advance in order to get to the anime, because I really wanted to discuss the anime with you guys and enjoy it with you guys and take part in all the conversations and all the crazy shit. So this is an apology from the past to you guys, so I'm sorry for that, but I hope it's worthwhile. I hope Future Kuma does right by you and gets this shit edited done right, and I hope everything goes well. Anyway, on with the show! Ooh, and another thing. Guys, I'm gonna start saying this every single time. If you have a favorite part of the video, put a timestamp. Your favorite bits, you put a little timestamp. These are my favorite moments. I am gonna cut up all the favorite moments and do a highlight reel sometime in the future when we finish the game. And also be sure to hit like, because those likes actually do help with these videos. The more likes and we get, the better the video is stats-wise, which means we're going to get more people watching them, because this video is going to be recommended to other Danganronpa fans, which is what we want. We want more people on board, more good stuff happening, and that way when we get the highlight reels, they're going to be good highlights. We're going to have a lot more bits that people liked, and hopefully your highlight moment makes it, and then it's just going to look awesome. So please, highlight moments. Feel free, if you're re-watching Danganronpa 1, to do the same. I want to make cool highlight videos for these long games because I fucking love it. Let's have some fun with this. I forgot what we were supposed to do. Morning of the second night, doesn't really matter. Let's just leave. I don't even know what we have to do. As if by habit, I left my cottage, and I just so happened to bump into a certain someone. Oh, Mr. Yakuza. Huh. Oh, it's you, Fuyuhiko. How lucky I have to see your face this morning. Did I do this last time? Maybe, maybe not. Just so you know, I don't want to talk to you at all. I'm in a really bad mood right now. Then what the fuck are you doing outside my cottage? It's not like you're going to the restaurant now, right? Were you planning to go somewhere else?
Shut up!
Like I said, I don't want to talk to you. I'm just going back to my cottage. Leave me alone. Ah, right. He's on his period. Yeah, it happens once a month. You say you're going back. Did you go somewhere?
It's got nothing to do with you.
Hey, didn't I tell you I don't want to talk? Then why are you talking? Is it that game?
What?
What do you mean? It's true. What do you have in your hand? Hey, what's that envelope? What's inside? Shut up. What makes you think you have any right to question me? Okay. I'm not trying to question you. I was just... Are you saying you don't like the fact I acted on my own without consulting you guys? I wouldn't mind throwing Fuyuhiko a line here. The same way Hajime is. But... the way he's going is not going to end well in this killing game, because he has absolutely no respect or trust for anyone, and it's going to be a little difficult for people to watch his back or throw him a line if he's being an asshole like this, because he's public enemy number one, he's got a lot of targets on his back, he's pretty much trying to make enemies with everyone for absolutely no reason, which is a stupid decision from a tactical point of view. And if any mysterious murders do happen, he's gonna be public enemy number one. So I don't know what his intention or plan is, but whatever it is, it's not going to actually end well. So let's see how it goes. I hope this little kid wisens up, because the way he's going, he's either gonna end up getting murdered, which I find highly unlikely, But I think the more likely thing is he's going to try to murder someone using Nagito. Nagito will probably get killed, and this kid's just going to be public enemy number one. He's going to have no alibis, he's not going to be able to manipulate people because everyone hates him, and they're all going to assume the worst from him, which in the end is going to backfire just because he's got no social, social capital to sort of bank on. So, I don't know, a little bit of a wise chat, but let's continue. Is there something wrong with that, huh? Are you going to tie me up like Nagito? Alright, so he's afraid. He's definitely afraid because he sort of sees that he's in an environment where he's sort of not in a good position. He's not top dog. He doesn't have a lot of power, so he has to bark. He's in a weakened sort of position where he has to bark a lot in order to, you know, make people feel a bit scared of him. But at the end of the day, he's one kid surrounded by all these other people. He can't do much. Seriously, I didn't mean...
Dumbass!
Don't talk to me ever again. If you do, I swear I'll fucking kill you. It reminds me of a chihuahua. That guy is going to be dangerous if we leave him alone. Yeah, there's nothing more dangerous than an animal that feels cornered. They bite. I should let everyone know, but I should be careful not to make too much trouble. See, my room's here. Okay. So that sort of makes sense why we bumped into each other. His room's sort of... Oh, okay, I got my level. His room's sort of close to us, and we are here. Okay, let us continue. I think we were going to go to the morning meeting. Let's talk to Gundam, that hopefully does not have a Gundam. My stomach is killing me because I had a very chilly burrito. So drinking coffee and energy drinks is kind of weird. And I had some alcohol earlier with a mate. So I've got a couple uppers, I've got a couple downers. But nothing beats these pink, blue, and purple pills. D12, Purple Pills. Excellent song, I love it. There's also a parody for it, for World of Warcraft, which is pretty good. Oh my god, my stomach is killing me! I should stop having that chili sauce, because it's bad for my insides. The wind is very quiet. I do hope it is not an ominous portent. Is that it? That's all you were gonna say? Fine. Pekko, how's it going?
It appears.
I did see Fuyuhiko earlier, but it does seem he isn't going to join us for breakfast today as well. I have some things I'd like to think about. I'm going to go for a little walk. Fair enough. I don't think anyone's going to tell us anything particularly important before breakfast, so I don't think I'm going to bother looking for everyone to talk to, but if I do meet them on the way, I will talk to them, because I'm trying to find out a little bit more about every single character, because things could go somewhere. Oh, nice timing. I've been waiting for anyone to come by at a time like this. Waiting, huh?
Hey.
Yeah, I was thinking about delivering this. Okay. Is this someone's breakfast? Ah, that is for Nagito. Milk, bread, and a little bit of, what is that? Butter or honey? Because it's got the little bee. I mean, if we just leave him all tied up, he's going to starve. Yeah, if we leave him tied up and he starves, who gets the kill? The person that tied the rope, the person that knocked him out? How does it work? I'm curious. Like, how long are they planning to continue this? Okay. I need a couple of minutes. I feel like Eric Cartman after burritos. Oh, I am back. I was thinking the entire time, is it appropriate to tell people that I am going for a shit? And then I realized that there is a character on Danganronpa 2 that does that very same thing. Please focus on me, thank you. So, why the fuck can I not say that I gotta take a shit after I had a very spicy burrito? The more we play this game of Danganronpa, the more shit I say that in other situations would be totally inappropriate. So I thank you for joining me on this journey of Danganronpa, where I could say things which in other circumstances would have me socially ostracized. So thank you. I appreciate it. Like, how long are they planning to continue this? Well, there's no way we can keep him tied up forever. You would be surprised how long you can keep someone tied up.
Aww.
Yeah, that's what I thought at first, but maybe it's better if he was tied up forever. Ooh, I like you a little more now. And I like that wink. You get a point. She gets a point for that. Mahiru gets a point. Oh my god, this is her first point. Mahiru Ranga. 1 point. Oh, by the way, I am going to ask one of those questions now. How many points does Ibuki have so far? I'm just going to write this down. F6. Answer. It should pretty much be this. I know the answer. If you know the answer, put it in the comment section below. I will keep a tally. You might win a Kuma coin prize of some sort later down the track. What does that mean? Well, it means whatever you want it to mean, Hajime. I actually went to see Nagito earlier. I kind of brought him breakfast.
Jeez.
And then listen to this. He seriously pisses me off.
Do you understand?
He said he doesn't like rice, so he wanted toast instead. Doesn't he understand the situation he's in right now? I'm pretty sure he understands the situation, but he doesn't give a fuck. He's just like, woman, bring me a sandwich. And you complied. Please don't hate me. I understand that half my viewer base for Danganronpa is female. I'm not making a sexist joke. I'm just pointing out what he did. He told Mahiru to go make him a sandwich. And she did. So that's why you're running back and forth. That must be hard for you. You have no idea.
Really?
Hard? Do you really think so? Oh god, oh god, she's pitching the whole I'm a good housewife material sort of thing.
Hey!
Now bring this to Nagito on my behalf. Oh, fuck. you just got played, Hajime. Huh?
Jeez.
I was forced to run back and forth too many times. I'm done being his maid. Maid? And ties people up? Wow, I would give you a bonus point, but, you know, you didn't say anything about... And not only that, I just remembered that I have a little business to take care of. Business?
Thank you.
So thank you, I'll leave the rest to you. Bang bang! You get a bonus point for playing Hajime. You get a bonus point. So far, I thought you were one of the most boring characters in Danganronpa, but you get that bonus point for showing that you have those qualities that make women... interesting. Mahiru pushed the tray to my hands and ran before I could object. I'm gonna drink the rest of this coffee and then move on to my energy drink because I only had a 2-hour cat nap earlier today before I went out again. Weekends. I went shooting today, by the way. This is the first time I've shot in about a year, and I only shot 15 bullets that last year. And before that, it was 2-3 years before I was shooting. Before that, it was when I was a kid. And surprisingly enough, I'm still pretty decent with a handgun. I embarrassed my friend that brought me to the gun range. I feel bad for him. They were doing the thing because in Australia, you've got the regulation where once you finish firing, you're essentially facing the front. You finish firing, you unload the clip, and you have to show the slide to the guy that's watching, the supervisor, to show him that there's no bullet in the chamber. And after a while, he's just like, you don't have to show it to me anymore. You don't have to use two hands. You need more distance. Try firing with one hand, like try a trick shot. And this is my first time firing where I was trying to register for a membership at that gun club. And they were just like, yeah, it was like, which one of you is trying to apply? Oh, me. And the guy just looks at me and is like, you'll need the following paperwork. It's gonna take this long. And after that many months, you can register for your own firearm. He's like, which one do you like? The Glock 9mm or the USP? And I'm like, well, if I was firing at the range like this, borrowing, I would borrow the Glock because it's a lot easier. It doesn't have the two-action shooting. It's lighter, you know, it's no thrills, very thin. But if I was to get one, I would definitely get the USP, more reliable. It's got the hammer, you know, two-stage firing, but it's a lot better. You can definitely feel the trigger a lot better. More reliable, you can attach the suppressor. It's a more universally superior weapon. It's not going to jam as much. But the Glock is a lot easier, which is why usually police use those, because it's idiot-proof. Not insulting our police force, but from what I hear at the firing range, those guys can't hit a moving target at 5 meters. It's pretty embarrassing. Let's continue. Jeez, it's always something. As I recall, he's tied up in the old building where the murder took place, right? Kyoko. I wish I could replace you for Kyoko. Can I maybe drown you in the pool? You're big enough that you wouldn't be able to fight back. Okay, that was dark. We're back in Danganronpa territory. That's Nagito's food, right? You should feel honored that Mahito asked you to bring him that. So you better feed him quickly. Honored? You said honored, you little cheeky thing. See, isn't that like he's a pet? It's kind of harsh. You want to poke his stomach so it makes funny noises? What are you doing out here? Hey, what are you doing? You kind of forced this on me, you know?
Hey!
Don't say I forced you, you're the one who agreed to do it, right? Ah! A bit like Julia Gillard.
Jeez.
Anyway, I have some things to do, but Hyoko said...
Jeez!
Hajime, you're in the way, Mihiro and I are gonna go to the supermarket right now. We're gonna get candy for each other, right?
Hey.
I know, but don't cling to me like that. It's hard to walk, okay? Then we can still hold hands. Yep, of course.
Hey.
I really can't spend too much time with you, okay? I have things to take care of.
Aww.
Oh, so boring. Let's ditch Hajime already and go.
Thank you.
Well then, Hajime, I'll leave it to you. Yoko's totally attached to Mihiro. They kind of look like sisters. I'm willing to bet that little girl did not have a lot of parenting and she really, really needs a mother figure or a big sister figure. Stop feeling sympathy for the psychos, Kuma.
You can't!
Oh, I love this song. I will one day want to dance to this. And I also love the Monokuma. It's like... One day, Kumas. When we become Oprah famous, we will play this music. Conventions and things like that, and we will dance to it, and everyone's gonna be like, what the fuck? And because of the fear of missing out, if we get a dozen or two dozen, if you watch that social experiment of how many people it takes in order to start a dance, you only need about two or three, and then you'll get hundreds of people getting into it. So we just need a handful of Kumas, and we can start this thing. We can create a Kumalution, a revolution, the most awful, most tragic event in human history. We could start this shit. I love this song. Wait, it's coming. It's building up. Oh my god, Danganronpa, you are climbing up on my favorite list so much, but you're not gonna take Metal Gear Solid down, because that shit breaks you down and rebuilds you. No. This old building is being renovated. You can't go inside. If I'm not allowed inside, why is Nagato inside? You know about it too, Hajime? Of course I know about it. We discussed it openly. Because Nakamura and Kuzuichi earnestly told me that Monomi's the only one we can rely on. And it's true that Nagato needs to reflect on his actions. I came here to deliver food to Nagato. It counts as murder if he ends up starving to death, right? So they sort of played your emotional string to let them sort of in, and this is not product placement, by the way, I'm just too lazy to do stuff. Played on your emotional strings, and now we're playing on your emotional strings. Monomi, like, you're a cool character, but you're too kind. Oh shit, mother of fuck. Fucking old. I got this from Japan, I fucking love it. Camo is out of season here for years. Japan, I love this shit. Love the Japanese fashion. It's more accepting. Honestly, I wouldn't mind spending 6 months a year in Japan and just on the crazy Friday, Saturday nights, just walk around Tokyo and just see all the crazy shit. The guys with leather jackets, the spiky hair, the punk rock, the Lolitas, cyber goths. Like, there's cool, crazy shit happening in Japan all the time. Like, you know, what's happening in Japan? Some crazy shit. It's sort of what attracted me to Japanese culture. The fact that there's crazy shit happening all the time. Starve? It's okay to go inside then?
Ta-da!
Yes! Make sure you tell him to chew thoroughly before he swallows. Swallows. Okay, that ended better than we originally anticipated. And more... What? My baby's born. My baby's a snake. Snake in me. Okay, so this thing just grows and then it gives me a present. That's cool. Let's go see Nagito. So Nagito's tied up at the back. Instinctively, I gulped back my dried saliva. Why am I so nervous? Pushing aside my nervous tension, I vigorously opened the door to the climbing hall. I firmly grasped the knob. I could feel my sweaty hands pressed against the metal. It was cold, yet warm. I slowly turned. I felt the click, and then I pulled. Okay, I just try to make turning the doorknob a sexual thing. I've been reading a little too much of 50 Shades of Grey. This book is awesome. The first, 80 or so pages are sort of interesting. They're romantic in a sense, even though the psychology of Christian is that he's a total psychopath and he's essentially indoctrinating, I can't pronounce it, Anastasia is basically manipulating her. Yeah, he's a psycho. He knows exactly what he's doing. He's separating her from people. But, the first 80 pages is good shit. After that, the realism goes to crap. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. The book was fine and somewhat realistic until Anastasia in the bathtub scene. But then again, let's just start Damaropa. Let's stop psychoanalyzing everything. I'm not a psychologist. I'm a marketing student and I study consumer behavior. So my psychological understanding is very limited, but when I see little things like that, I'm like, wait, hang on, there's something going on here. Oh, I do wish I did study psychology because it's super interesting. Dr. Kuma has such a nice ring to it. As I quietly peeked through the door, I saw him on the other side. He was waiting for me with a big smile on his face. You tied him up like that?
Could it be? Did you take time out of your busy day to bring some food to little old me?
So that's how you tied him up. That's not the best way to tie someone up, by the way.
Wow, I'm so happy. As you can see, I can't exactly greet you with my full hospitality, but feel free to relax.
I feel sorry for your balls. With your legs stuck together like that, your balls must be squashed. I hope someone at least had the decency to pull them forward. Shit, you know what? Sleeping as a guy is not easy. That was a little too graphic. I apologize. He was the same as usual. Unlike his smile, his words carried a certain heaviness. As if a black poison was falling from his mouth every time he spoke, filling his surroundings with darkness. Well, it's probably the despair, you idiot. An illusion, but one I couldn't help feeling at the moment.
Huh? What happened? Your face looks kind of scary.
Your face looks kind of scary.
I didn't come here to talk to you. I just came to bring you some food.
Yeah, eat it.
Come on, eat it.
Let's not take that out of context.
You're not going to feed me. Well, I can't eat it on my own. You know, since my hands are all tied up.
Be very careful. If he bites this finger, you could bleed to death. You do know why they put rings on this finger, right? Because it goes all the way to your heart. There's an artery here. So if he bites it, it's gone. And you should know that humans can actually bite off their fingers. They've got the strength in their jaw in order to do so. It's just that your brain tells you do not do this. Once you remove that little safety thing in there, you can literally do anything. You could literally grip things and pull with your muscles until you dislocate everything and pull every muscle in your body. It's possible, it's just our brains prevent us from doing so. It's all about mental strength.
Actually, I was really embarrassed to ask a girl to feed me, so I'm glad you're the one who came.
And Nagito X Hajime, confirmed. I'm sure there's plenty of fan art of this. Somewhere on DeviantArt. Good website, but creepy shit. Oh, I get it. Freaking Mahiru. That must be why she asked me to go instead of her.
Anyway, what happened to Mahiru? Did she leave saying she had some business to take care of?
Oh god, my stomach. I've been to the bathroom like 4 times in the past 3 hours. Jesus.
Huh? Why do you know that? By By the way, I heard about Twilight Syndrome murder case, was it? I have mixed feelings. I really liked that game a lot.
The fuck?
Don't change the subject. I'm asking you.
Oh well, a little disappointed. It's not like you Ultimates to ignore the threat that's standing right in front of you.
How does he have all this info? It's either Monokuma or Sami feeding him. Wait, who's been in contact with him? That's the person feeding info.
So are you really planning not to play the game? Do you think Monokuma will just let that slide?
I know he won't. He's a dick.
Well, that is, you guys should confront it. After all, hope springs when you confront despair.
No, it doesn't. He almost sounds reasonable. Running away from your problems isn't a solution. I'm just putting it off. It's already in your head. But
I don't want to be tricked by you anymore. Bye now.
Hey, Hajime, weren't you planning to feed me?
Well, would you settle for waterboarding?
Hey!
Waterboarding.
Hajime?
Fuck you. And somehow ended up back in my room. Damn it, I barely talked to him and I'm already not feeling so well. Neither am I. That burrito really fucked me up. But I really can't stop thinking about it. Is it really okay to leave the game alone? While I'm doing nothing about it, someone else is. No, nothing good can come from thinking about it. There's something else I need to do. Okay, we're gonna do free time, but first, I need that bathroom. So, I'll be back. Welcome back, Kumas. You're here with Present Kuma, who for you is Present Kuma, and for me is Past Kuma, and for future... Okay, I'm Kuma. Okay, let us just continue with the free time event. Okay, the burrito is finished. It's out of my system. I was in the bathroom about 4 or 5 times. A few hours have passed. I just finished answering my comments for that episode called The Tragedy. Yep, that's the one where I go around and I beg Kyoka to take us back. Yeah, I'm filming this the same night that came out. That's kind of weird to say. But I'm glad you guys enjoyed that episode. I'll try to... I now sort of see the limits that I can push with you guys. So we're kind of cool. Okay. Oh yeah, we got free time. Who have we been with so far? Luckily this game actually tells us how our progress is going and how close we are to characters. So we're halfway through Peko, halfway through Chikai, and 2 with Ibuki, which isn't too bad, and 2 with Sonya, and he is dead and he's a dick. And Monomi, we can't really do anything with Monomi. Let me just check if I have the gifts required for Chikai and the other ones, because I don't actually want to go there without going to a proper date. Ooh, Chikai's got 1 for 18. We're out. Ooh, sunflower seeds, we got them. So we've got 18 for Chikai. 33.41. We're out of 41, 62, 64. Alright, we've got the 62, we've got the 64. We've got everything we need for Chikai, so we are cool to go with Chikai. Are we cool to go with Peko by any chance? While she's sort of here. Okay, Peko likes some freaky shit. Funnily enough, we seem to have a gift that she likes. She likes an apron dress. I'm not here to judge. Okay, Peko. I don't understand why that game is so... I don't understand why that game is the motive at all. However,
no. This
isn't good. It might be good if I do some training to calm myself down. Yep. Saburi is always good. Just hitting that kendo stick. What should I do? Should I hang out with Peko? Of course you should. I'm going to train, but watching me would be boring. Would you like to try too? Of course. I love playing with my sword. I mean swords. I'll teach you how to properly grip a bamboo sword. It's called a shinai, Harley. Harley? You're not a Harley Davidson, you're a darling. I wasn't gonna say darling, why did I say Harley? Did I say Harvey? Would it be creepy? I spent time today learning how to wield a bamboo sword from Peko. I think Pekko and I grew a little closer. What do you mean think? You think. Make up your mind. Would you like to give Pekko a present? Of course I would. And we're going to give her an apron dress. A dress that resembles a maid's uniform. When you wear it, this might seem... I could not read what it said. Is it really acceptable for me to receive this? Yes. Yes, it is.
No.
No, I will not question your sincerity. Thank you, Hajime. She reminds me of Saber from Fate's Day Night. She's very formal. Oh crap, she's got the same hairstyle. Oh crap, she's literally Saber. Oh crap! Okay then. Well, I was always more a Rin girl myself, but Saber's cool. I mean, if she's good enough for Gilgamesh, he's obviously good enough for all of us. Even though he's a dick. Bigger dick than Byakuya, and that's saying something. It feels like she's making an even more intense face than usual. Yep, she wants to rip my clothes off. I mean, Hajime's clothes off. Are we becoming one? No, no. Is she worried about something? I can't tell if I should ask or not. What the hell? Why is she making that face? Hey, are you alright? You're starting to turn pale.
What?
Was I? What? What were you even trying to do?
No.
Well, actually, I think she was trying to poop. I was trying to smile. That was her trying to smile? Huh? My Hiru told me that I'm the only one who doesn't smile for her pictures. So I thought I should do something about it, but it's harder than I thought. You know, smiling uses, I think, 2-3 muscles. And if you do it for 20 seconds, endorphins start releasing and you start feeling happy. And smiling also reduces wrinkles, so it makes you look younger. So if you frown, you actually get older. If you smile, you feel happier. Even if you're not happy and you just smile, like, for fakesies. Works.
Hey.
So were you trying to make me laugh? Okay. Let's tell a good joke. Wanna hear a joke? Wait, you cannot- oh shit. I take that back? Not funny. How much does a polar bear weigh? Enough to break the ice! No? Not a fan of polar bears? You can always ask Penguin. This is sudden. Anything is fine as long as it's funny, so give it a try. You're acting like you lowered the bar, but it's still really high.
Yippee.
I know. If it's possible, I'd like to have something to do with- I'd like it to have something to do with animals. How much does a polar bear weigh? Do it. There might be something that stirs warm feelings inside me. That may be, but... then... Elephant, turtle, panda. Panda's close enough to a bear. A panda walks into a restaurant, eats, shoots, and leaves. Shoots? A panda with a gun? Sounds a bit like me.
Yes.
I already know they do that. Well, fuck. Crap! I botched the delivery. It's not even that clever of a joke. However, pandas are nice. Their white and black fur is very adorable and fluffy. I'll take that as a compliment. Someday I would like to try touch one. Why does she go like this and then lift her boobs? And why does she have big boobs like that? Why do all the girls in this game have big boobs like that? Let's be honest, their frame is not wide enough to support that much weight on the front. And going by the size of their shoulders and arms, they don't have the body fat in order to accumulate all the fat on their chest in order to have boobs of that size. Because if anyone knows how body fat works, you can't just get rid of fat on one particular area of the body or lose body fat without losing fat across your entire body. And my stomach hurts, I'm probably hungry. But it is 6 a.m. and I really want to play. So we've got Saber here, called Pekko, who likes pandas, and would really like to touch a fluffy white and black panda. Yes. Yes. Hey guys, I'm not the one with the dirty mind. You guys put that in your heads. You filthy god. Get out your minds out of the gutter. Pekka's face seemed to soften a little when she said that. Even though my joke completely failed to land, well, I guess this will do.
I apologize.
You helped me, Hajime. I can't really smile that well. I've been like this ever since I was young. Well, so am I, but, you know, I do my best. The childhood friend I always played with used to cry and say my face was scary. There was also a time when my first love coldly told me that too. That is a terrible thing to say. Oh baby, I love you too. By the way, your face is scary. What? The only circumstance in which I would say that saying such a thing to a girl is appropriate if she's literally looking like this. The entire time. That would just be freaky. That would just be super freaky. That would just be beyond freaky. Like, she's just looking like... without blinking. Just looking at you the entire time. The entire time, without blinking. Expressionless, just... That would be the creepiest fucking experience in the world. The most awkward. But even I wouldn't say anything. I'd just be like... want to change positions. Maybe turn around, or I turn around. Wait, why the fuck would I turn around? What the fuck? The fuck was that about? Even so, I never really needed to smile, so I never thought about it all that much. And because I completely neglected it, I forgot how to do it entirely. It's not normal for someone to forget how to smile. Was she subjected to an outrageous amount of harsh training? Or is there some other reason?
Hey.
Hajime, what's wrong? Nothing. Anyways, I'll make sure to tell you a funny joke next time. That would be wonderful, I'll be looking forward to it. I kept chatting with Pekka for a while and spent some time thinking of ideas for funny jokes. Fair enough. We updated Pekka's history. After parting ways with Pekka, I decided to return my room for now. I feel a little bit bad for her just because... that is a terrible thing to tell a girl. Your face is scary. The fuck, dude. The fuck. Like, what kind of asshole would do that? Seriously. I mean, I'm one of the most... sounds a little high, so it hurts my ears, but we're okay. Now, let's see where Chikai is. Because, oh no. Hell no, I am not going with toilet paper, boy. Not gonna happen. No, I don't give a shit about your toilet paper. Fuck your toilet paper. Chikai is so reliable. I don't even have to check the map where she is. She's just here. I like that. She's reliable.
Well?
Whenever I'm playing games, I get a strong urge to eat whatever food appears in the game. So do I. We call it product placement, which is why you should never go shopping when you're hungry. Or watch TV with commercials when you're hungry. You will get very hungry. And have you also ever noticed that fast food chains, restaurants, and commercials mostly use warm colors like red, orange, and yellow? It's because those colors simulate hunger. That's why they don't use blue. Blue actually makes you feel full. So, if you always get hungry when you're on a computer, put yourself a light blue wallpaper. It works magic. All these little psychological things are amazing. So I guess I'm gonna eat donuts right now. And we got an Asahina. What should I do? Should I hang out with Chikai? Yeah, dude. You should.
Let's go.
I wonder if the supermarket has any donuts. Alright, I should go check. And I'm gonna go check what's in my pantry. Okay, so I made a boo-boo. I went to the fridge and I saw that I had some pasta left and I had some bolognese sauce cooked left. And I was like, there's a lot of meat here. A little bit of pasta. So I added all the meat to the pasta. It's like a gooey stuff. I'll actually show you guys. And I added cheese as well. So it's cheesy bolognese pasta. But then I added burrito sauce, the really spicy one. So all this meat was really spicy, which is good. And now I'm feeling my stomach and I'm like, oh shit, I did it again. So I can't really help myself, but she did mention food. So every now and then I'm gonna grab a bite and probably edit it out, but I'm freaking starving. Okay, so we went to the supermarket. We found donuts and spent time eating them and talking to each other. This is what I'm talking about, Hajime. This is the shit to get to a girl's heart. You get to a girl's heart through food. Food is the key. Food has been my secret weapon since day two. Because day one was a complete fuck up. Oh yeah, donuts. Gotta love them holes. Looks like Chika and I grew a little closer. Would you like to give Chika a present? Yes, I would! Let us give her the D, the donuts, which we do not have. Let's not give her this. Let's not give her this. Chika likes number 18, sunflower seeds. Let us give her this. Somewhat similar to peanuts, the flower itself represents the sun's watchful eye. Hope she likes it.
Hey.
You're giving this to me? Well, yeah, you just had something sweet. Doesn't that mean you need something salty? Thanks, I'll take good care of it and use it. It's a pack of sunflower seeds. Eat them. What? Every single time, I can't believe how quickly she falls asleep in such a short time. Look at the bright side! At least it won't be awkward if you fall asleep and start snoring, and then she's just lying there and says you sound like a bear. It's just funny. Samurai head, Statue of Liberty. Ah, don't shoot the beam there. This is bad. Zombie nation eating up humans. Is she dreaming about a game? I have no idea what kind of game she's talking about.
Sorry.
Oh, sorry, I think I was sleeping again. I think so too, but that's a lot of drool. Were you playing a video game in your dream too? Yeah, it was fun because it was a shooting game. I like this girl already. I see you like those kind of games.
Yep.
I'm pretty all-inclusive. I'll play anything from Space Invaders to the latest military shooters. Have you played Metal Gear Solid? Chick that plays Metal Gear Solid is hard to come by. I also like simulation games. Right now, I mainly play real-time strategy games, but I also like turn-based ones too.
Hey.
So where do you want to go today? I like this. How about we go to the ranch today? I don't really like animals that much. You don't like animals? Okay, you lose a point, Chikai. Losing here, I'm not gonna take a point away from you, but... Really? They're warm when you touch them, you know? That's a little scary. That's not gonna end well on a personal basis, because... I'm warm. No, seriously, I am really, really warm. Like, in Japanese winter, you know when you're like in winter and it's cold and it's snowing, like 10 degrees, below 10 degrees, you know, it's like 5, 6 degrees during the night. I'm warm. Give me a bed sheet and I'm good. Summer in Australia? Shit, I don't even need that. The only reason I use this thing in winter is it's warm enough to make me fall asleep quicker. That and I was told that if I'm sleeping with too few bed sheets, my body generates more body fat. You know, a little bit like penguins, bears, and walruses. So if it's cold, my body generates more body fat in order to keep me warm. So I started putting more and more bed sheets so I hopefully lose weight. Not that I'm like worried that I need to lose weight, I just want to lose some body fat because, I don't know. I would like to have more defined muscles and physique. But it doesn't help that I'm eating pasta with cheese at 5 a.m. But what can you do? Eating makes you feel like it's breakfast and it makes you awake. So it's healthier than drinking more energy drinks, pre-workout and soft drink. But if you eat 4 hours before you sleep, you're gonna get fat because you're not gonna use up all that energy anyway. It's gonna get stored into fat. So shit. Oh, don't worry. This ain't vodka. I just do acting for the Russian React crap. Quite literally, I can't believe some people think it's vodka. Do you guys not understand what satire is? I clearly say in the description, I'm not Russian, I'm Serbian, and this video is satire. I don't understand. Oh, whatever. They're warm when you touch them, you know? That's a little scary. It's kind of hard to guess what they'll do next. Okay.
Well?
I'm better at games that use precise calculations where success and failure is decided by numerical values. But it's hard for me to play games where I have to manage relationships and guess what characters are feeling. So you're a completely completely different gamer from me. Me, I try to understand the characters, whereas you just sort of try to understand the situation and sort of do a strategy. Try to beat the game. That's cool. I see. Maybe that has something to do with her upbringing. Maybe she's just sort of didn't spend a lot of time around people. That's possible. I don't want to do things Chikai would hate, but it feels lonely just to leave her like this. If she's kind of scared of animals, why don't you go with her and be patting the animal before she touches it so the animal is nice, docile, and calm, and that way she gets the fear out? Maybe? Would be a bonding experience, perhaps? How about we look at the animals from afar? Baby steps, dude. Baby steps. The ones at the ranch are pretty tame. You can even try to touch them if it looks safe. Okay.
I think.
If you teach me lots of things, it'll probably be okay, I think. Yeah, that's your role. Be a sort of... guardian? That sounded creepy? Just sort of look out for her? You know? I mean, that's what guys traditionally are supposed to do. I'm all cool with this, gender roles and equality, but at the end of the day, I still believe that the guy should open the door for the woman, pull out the chair, and, you know, get up when you greet a woman and not continue sitting down. I think that's just courteous. I mean, women these days can confuse it with flirting because there's very few gentlemen left, but, you know, it's just how I was brought up. Is she relying on me? If so, that makes me happy. We've got another Naegi. Chika and I decided to walk to the ranch. Ah, we get a photo. That's cool. I thought it was just going to be blank. And then we go back to where we were, because that's boring. I like going through these actual events. Oh my, it's a cow. I wonder if it's going to dance like the one in Dancing Eyes. No, maybe if you kill enough of them, you go to the secret cow level. It might be a little difficult. Maybe I should try touching it a little. You know what would actually be fun? Actually be fun? If you calm the cow, and she milks the cow. Think about it. Think about it for a minute. She's afraid to touch the cow. I highly doubt she's ever done something like that. Cows, if they're full of milk, they're not going to run around because it's actually pretty painful for them. So they're going to let you, you know, drain milk. And that would be such a memorable experience for a girl like this, who's I wouldn't say afraid of animals, but sort of freaked out by them, to milk a cow. That would be a memorable date as fuck. You should do that. That would be a good thing to do. Chika walked up to the cow and cautiously pet its back. The cow seemed not to mind and continued silently eating grass. Wow, it's really warm. Well, that's because it's alive. I see. You're right. Except for cold-blooded animals. You shouldn't pat those. I like humans. Animals don't mind being touched that much. So that might make it easier for me. If you touch a person, something is born from that interaction, right? Repulsion, anticipation, whatever. I'm nervous about stuff like that. It makes me think I'm better off not doing anything unnecessary. On the way back, you should hold her hand. Just walk along and just slowly sort of, you know, brush your hand against hers a few times. Let her warm up to it. When she notices it, you'll know the cue. She'll probably look down and be wondering what the hell. She'll get used to it. If you feel the vibe that she's not nervous, you just gently, you know, grab it. You don't break a fucking hand. Just gently just hold it. You don't even grip it. You just sort of hold it enough, like an open cup hold. Essentially how you hold a handgun, essentially, you know. You hold a handgun like this with your right hand, and this one's the cup hold. You just slowly grab it, just hold it, That way, you know, she doesn't feel threatened. She doesn't feel like her hand's being held or she's being, you know, strangled. It's a comfortable hold. Focus on me. And that way she sort of gets this... You gonna focus on me or not, you stupid camera? That way she gets out of this whole fear and it's gonna be a memorable date. The date where she touched or milked a cow and you held her hand. That is romantic as fuck. You should do that, Hajime. So, Hajime. Like, it's better if I just stay an innocent bystander for as long as I can. I am not gonna make a comment about that. Chikai's feelings seemed a little odd, but I do understand where she's coming from. I hope one day she can touch not just cows, but people too. You said yourself, she's relying on you. Grow some balls and take the initiative. Gender roles aside, grow some balls. You know, if we milk this cow, I'm sure the fresh milk must be really tasty. Oh, holy shit, Hajime said that. You are, that's good. Okay. Hajime, if you don't fuck this up, you get a point.
Hey.
Milk this cow? Huh? You know that milk comes from cows, right? What do you mean, from? Milk is milk, right? Okay, so she's not the sharpest tool in the shed. That's cool. You can deal with that. As long as it doesn't become a legal problem later on. You know, if you pull a cow's udders, milk comes out. You only need one cow to get as much milk as you want. No, it takes the cow time to make the milk. You can't milk it to death. That's where the saying comes from. Milking a cow to death. Like Activision is milking the Call of Duty franchise to death. The cow's been dead for a while, guys. Stop milking.
Huh?
As much as you want. But if you try to cut open a milk bottle, a cow comes out of it, right? I'm just gonna eat some pasta and try to process this. But if you try to cut open a milk bottle, a cow comes out of it, right? You do know in Japan, they open some eggs, got a cup, put that clear Glad wrap, and put the oak on that Glad wrap, and warmed it, and the embryo started growing, like a little chicken was born from it. Without the eggshell in Japan. I don't think she knows about that. I don't think she's very sciencey. I don't think she's very anything without games. Which will kind of explain why she's really good at games, but really bad with people. She's got that typical hardcore gamer sort of mentality. Without sounding stereotypical, she sounds like a Russian or Korean gamer, like hardcore as fuck. Except the Russians are crazy. They game during the day, and then they blow shit up at night. Except those fuckers from the military that gave firecrackers to that bear. I would flay them to the raw nerve. I hate cruelty to animals. I fucking love animals. People that do that, I feel nothing for those people. Flame to death. Get a bottle of vinegar and a paintbrush and start having fun. If they black out, give them some adrenaline. And bring them back to life as many times as you want. Amen. You torture animals. Oh man, you're fair game. You think Junko's bad? Fuck man, me and Junko would be perfect together. She can teach me the ways of despair. Too bad she's dead. I'm gonna miss her. And it dances, right? I knew it, it's definitely dancing eyes. How old is this girl again? High school? It's okay. She was a uni student. We have a problem. Seriously, what kind of game is she talking about? Just roll with it, dude. Roll with it. I explain how milk works to Chikai in detail. Okay. Why are there so many things she doesn't know? As usual, Chikai is full of mysteries. So what, dude? Just roll with it. Chica's report card has been updated based on your experience with her. I did not want to read that report card. I did not want to read it. Chica started to feel sleepy from playing too much. So after sending her off, I returned to my room. Sending her off. What do you mean, sending her off? I hope you mean as in the way of you take her to the boat, she boards the boat, and then you walk away. As in you took her back to her room, right? I hope. You still don't get a point because you didn't, like, get... Fuck it, you get a point. You get a point. I promised you a point if you don't fuck it up. But you could have got a bonus point if you held a hand. Pussy. What's his name? Hajime? Does he even have a point? Oh, he's got a point. Alright, you get another point. Oh, I just gave away a tip about how many points Hajime has so far. I do that a lot, don't I? Paying attention to Kuma class. Let's see if I can get this. Oh no, I only know the number. You know, I actually work up my girlfriend with, why the fuck do I keep mentioning my girlfriend? Well, it's true. I work up with my girlfriend with the whole, good morning everyone, speech from, Danganronpa 1, and she recognized it. And then I realized she's probably watching these videos. That's gonna be fun.
Ahem! Hope Speak Academy School Trip Executive Committee has an announcement to make.
I'm working on the lip syncing.
It is now 10 p.m. Please return to your rooms and relax. Let the sound of the ocean gently rock you to sleep. Now then, sweet dreams, everyone. Good night.
Yeah, I'm gonna get good at lip syncing Monokuma. Maybe one day they need someone to voice Monokuma and I can do it. Or maybe they come up with a new Kuma. A Ninja Kuma. I wouldn't mind that. I'd voice the Ninja Kuma. I'd definitely sue you first, but I'd voice the Ninja Kuma. Hey, intellectual property, motherfuckers, that's mine. This isn't some of that Fine Bro shit where I'm gonna copyright the word react. But if someone goes out there and makes a Kuma that is a ninja and looks like my Ninja Kuma, and says things like my Ninja Kuma, I'm luring her up, assholes. On any other night, I'd probably just go to sleep. But I can't stop thinking about that game. It's not like I believe what Nagito said. It's just not a good idea to leave it alone. Twilight Syndrome murder case, huh? I should give it a try, just a little, just to see how it is. So you're worried that someone else is gonna try it, and so you're going to try it. This is not gonna end well, buddy. You shouldn't be doing this, buddy. You should not be doing this. This is a bad idea. This is a bad. Well, isn't this interesting? The ultimate gamer is out of the room while we're waiting. Oh, shit. Oh, that's a lot of people out. Okay. Okay, let's speak, Chikai.
Huh?
Where are you going at this hour? The Monokuma announcement was just made. Well, if it makes you feel better, I'm not going to see another girl. And I'm doing something you're Bring her along. You've got an alibi. Bring her along. She's the ultimate gamer. That way you've got an alibi. No one's gonna think you're trying to murder someone because I don't think you can have an accomplice. It's kind of weird that this is happening after Danganronpa 1 and the rules that were added during Danganronpa 1 were not automatically added to Danganronpa 2. Personally, I would do that, but then again, Junko's dead, so whoever knows about those rules being added is probably dead too. Well, you know, what about you? What are you doing?
Hey.
I was about to go back to my cottage. Anyway, what about you? What do you mean, you know? Girls are naturally inquisitive like that, aren't they? I mean, even though she's a gamer and lacks any social experience, she really doesn't like having, questions in a conversation. It's cool. I'm used to being interrogated. I felt a little hungry, so I was thinking about getting a snack from either the restaurant or the supermarket. That's smart, because the restaurant is to the left and doesn't let you leave the compound. The supermarket's to the right, lets you leave the compound. And then you can always say, if the supermarket didn't have what you want, you went to the burger joint. I'm no expert at lying. I'm just sort of... Shut up. I see. Oh God, we've got another Kyoko. So I'll be going now. See you later.
Hajime.
Uh-oh. Yep. That look. She just went from two. Hajime? Huh?
Yep.
Good night. I'll see you tomorrow. I feel like she totally saw through me. She's a chick. And you, sir, are the worst liar I have ever met. Let's see what these two are. Okay, that fucking grin is creepy as fuck. No wonder Sonya's, you know, not interested. Apart from the fact that you look like a garbage man. Not that there's anything wrong with a garbage man, but you look like a banana at the same time. Bananas in pajamas. You don't know who the bananas in pajamas are? Okay. Yep, you're a creepy fucker. What's with that laugh? You sound creepy. Exactly. Can't help myself, I just heard something big. Your face right now is even more creepy than before.
Right.
Whoa there, I can't give any details yet. But when the time comes... Now then, I'm gonna go to bed already. I'll see you tomorrow. What the fudge was that about? What the fuck, Sonya? He would have done something to Sonya. Okay, Nakamura, tell me what's up.
Oh,
it's you, Hajime. What are you doing up this... Oh yeah, when I talk to people, I get XP. God, I should be doing this earlier. Well, I felt like stargazing a bit. So I just came out here for a short walk. Okay, if you're gonna lie... At least use the same lie on all the fucking people. Otherwise, you're just gonna be creating a mess which you later cannot explain.
Huh?
Huh, I see. There's a lot of nasty things happening on this island. But the nature and scenery is quite superb.
However,
don't be out too late. It might hinder you tomorrow. Yeah, I'll make sure it's don't stay out too late. Well, he's staying here. Hey, Pekko! I hope you don't mind that little thing with Chikai.
Have a minute.
Hajime, good timing. There's something I wanted to ask you. Well, we're busted. Me? What is it?
No.
I wanted to hear your... I mean, a general opinion. I actually wish this was vodka right now. I am glad that this is not a real-time game because... Oh god, my stomach hurts. Shit. I hope I'm not having a fucking stomach or heart attack. God, YouTuber dies of a heart attack while filming Danganronpa. Does that count as a Monokuma kill? Oh, by the way... If you're doing speed dating, ask the girl the following question if you're a guy. If I die, what do you do? If she says, put your hard drives in the microwave and hit start, put a ring on it. I wanted to hear your, a general opinion. Huh? Is this about what we were discussing earlier? So you're going to him for advice. A guy that's an expert at dealing with people. Shit. Fair enough. What Pekko and Nakamura talking about? Well, you just sort of made a girl laugh. And she started talking about her ex. Keyword being ex. And you started talking to another girl within her sight. Do the math.
Anyway.
Regarding my inquiry. Arms folded, defensive stance. Yep. She's a pretty closed book at the moment. Do Nakamura and I really look like we're cosplaying as characters from a fighting game? Oh, fuck, you had me worried for a minute. I was about to lose my breath. I would say no, based on the fact that she's sounding very defensive about it. And she doesn't strike me as the type of person that would take that as a compliment because she's wearing what she's wearing out of practicality rather than vanity. Plus, you don't want to accidentally insult a girl. I learned that white lies are acceptable as long as you do not hurt the person's feelings. Because in the past, I used to be too honest, and my honesty would hurt the feelings of the people asking for my honest opinion. Which is kind of weird, considering you asked for my honest opinion, and then you wish I told you the lie. People are weird, so I typically ask them, well, I warn them, that if they ask for my honest opinion, I tend to give my honest opinion, which is not valued. And then sometimes people are cool with it, and sometimes they just sort of keep bringing up that I should be a little more delicate. In which case, I just start being delicate. In this case, I would say take the delicate approach, just because you don't want to hurt the girl's feelings. She's already taking a step to smile, be more social. You don't want to sort of push her a step back and force her to sort of start changing how she's, you know, dressing and whatnot. Just make her feel like there's people out there that accept her the way she is and she needs to change absolutely nothing. Whether or not that's 100% true at this point in time is not that important. Yeah, what do you guys think? You think it's okay to lie for the right reason or tell the truth for the wrong reason? What's the wrong reason of telling the truth? What happened to the truth is always the best approach? It's not, sometimes. When a cop pulls you over and asks you, Mr. Kuma, were you aware that you were driving 80 in a 20 zone? And you say, no, officer, I was not. And he asks you, are you sure? I say, yes, officer, I was not looking at the speedometer. He says, what were you looking at? I say, the road, officer. The road. I don't think that would work. Huh? Cosplay? Nice. Pretend like you don't know what that is. Smooth, buddy. Smooth.
Sheesh.
When I walk down the street, I'm often told, I look like a fighter from this game or a martial artist from that game. This is where you say, well, I sort of, I would say something like, well, when I first saw you, I thought you were some sort of bodybuilder or martial arts athlete, because that's the image, or that's the sort of body that you have. That way it's a compliment. It's similar enough to what they're accusing him of. And he would like that. Because a man that spends that much time on his physique likes to have it noticed. Big hint, ladies. Your man's at the gym 3-4 times a week, pumping those weights. Pretend like you notice. He does the same for you. And if he doesn't, he's a dick.
Fool!
I can't understand why they're talking about. No matter how you look at it, I'm only a team manager. Well, you've got the hairstyle of that Jin Kazama guy from Tekken. You've got, like, the muscles of, I don't know, every fucking stereotypical Street Fighter dude. And you're dressed like a bikie. You've got a chain around your neck, for Christ's sake. No matter how I look at it, that's certainly not true. That happens to me too. One time I was concerned by a strange group of people holding cameras. It was very annoying. Oh, this one time I was cornered by a strange group of people holding cameras. It was very annoying. So what did you do? If you don't understand polite requests to stop, it's not my fault if I'm forced to get a little violent. I like a little spice. I think it's better if I don't know the details. I'll give you the short version. She probably whacked him over the head or just poked him in the throat. My peko, we must confirm it with Hajime. Okay. Go with the compliment approach. First, say it as a compliment. Your physique is very powerful, very masculine, which is what protagonists in these type of games portray. And that. Peko, I would say something like, no, you don't look like you're cosplaying to me at all. To me, it looks like you're going to kendo training. Leave it at that. Mention nothing about the uniform, just going to kendo training. Leave it as open to interpretation as possible in the positive light. Don't leave it open to interpretation in the negative light. Especially with women and their appearance. Don't. No matter how others view us, we are ourselves. There is nothing to worry about.
I apologize.
You're right, I agree. I apologize, Hajime. Just forget about it.
Now that you
mentioned... So anyway, why are you here? What are you doing out so late? Shit. I'd say I was just going for some tea. Or a drink. And then later make your way to the supermarket. I was hungry, but they didn't have what I wanted in the kitchen. I wanted some ice cream, yes. I wanted some vanilla and caramel with chocolate on the outside. Just thin enough to keep the vanilla frozen so the ice cream doesn't melt. The vanilla in the middle. You know the one I'm thinking of. It's that half-half. Half of it is like a vanilla sandwich. The other half is chocolate on the outside, vanilla and caramel on the inside. It's very tasty. It's about 650 calories, but it's worth it. Well, I couldn't really go to sleep, so I was thinking about going for a little walk. So you're telling one person you're going for a walk. You're telling the other person you're going for a stroll looking at the stars. You're telling another person you're going to the supermarket or the kitchen. You, my friend, are going to be the suspect when a body turns up. I see. Be careful then. It doesn't mean anything is going to happen, but you should be careful, just in case. Okay, why is my height here? If I go like this, the angle is upwards. My height is not here, right in her boobs. Not that I'm complaining. Personally, I think that is a perfectly fine height to be, because whatever, but whatever, whatever. I'm a tits and ass man, a tits and ass man. You know, I haven't actually heard that song, I'm a tits and ass man. I just know from people that they say I'm a tits and ass man. Maybe we should go to the supermarket and at the very least be seen by someone at the supermarket. Making a fake alibi. Just trying to make a fake alibi. Okay, we've been spotted. Make sure you say hi. Hajime. Hiro, what are you doing here? Yeah, about that. I was thinking about taking a picture of the ocean at night. Sure you were. The ocean at night, isn't that dangerous? Be careful. Ah, you flipped the tables. It's very good. Wait, that's not gonna help. She's gonna rat you out in an instant. That's how women work. No offense, ladies, but there's a lot more honor and loyalty amongst men than there is amongst women. I know what happens when two best friends like the same guy. They tear into each other. One of them gets him, friendship's dead. Neither of it get him. Oh, let's never do that again. Ladies, there's honor amongst guys. We're up front. Bro calls dibs. We honor that. The bro says, hell no, I don't want that. Another bro likes a girl. Says it to his bros. His bros understand. His bros don't ask questions. Bros wingman. His bros jump on grenades. They distract the manager. They buy the drinks. Hell, they even take the manager home if they have to. They make the ultimate sacrifice so that their bro has a shot. Get your minds out of the gutter. I meant to take her home, not take her to bed. Jesus.
Thank you.
Yeah, sure thing. Bye. We can pin this on Mahito as long as no one sees us. She seems pretty agreeable. Usually she'll say something like, mind your own business. Why not she said that? Well, she's suspicious. We can rat her out, save our own hides if we have to. Okay, now you're gonna say there's no loyalty here, Kuma. You're a hypocrite. You're a prick. You're a chauvinist pig. You're just like all the others. I thought you were different. I'm in a battle royale, darling. What do you expect me to do? Let's go in the market and be seen in the market. I should go over to the park for now. You are fucking retarded, aren't you? Here I am trying to help you with an alibi. Clean the poop in your pet. And here you are, quite literally, gonna get yourself killed. Because you didn't complete your alibi. You didn't go to the store. You didn't leave traces of you being in the store. You didn't remove some items from the store that you can put in your room, like wrappers, to solidify your alibi. To make it seem like you went there more than once to explain the time gap. Hajime, you disappoint me. Okay, my stomach really hurts and I'm beginning to feel lightheaded. I had some food in my gut, so it's not the food. I had water, so it's not the hydration. It might be the chili. But there's no food in my gut, so there's nothing to poop. It's not gonna end well. Maybe all the chili has really fucked up the insides of my stomach. Really stop eating those burritos. I had 3 burritos in the past 2 days. They were delicious. I like them a lot. Oh yeah, island too. Wait, let's look at the map while we're here and see where everyone is. Because this map thing is bullshit. It doesn't tell us who's where. Okay, oh, so that's Monokuma Rock. That's the thing we couldn't see before. Who's that? Oh. So Buki and Thingo in there. Okay. Okay. Who's in these areas? No one's here. Okay. So no one's there. Can I tell if people are in their rooms? Because I don't know where the Yakuza kid is. No, wait. What? Fuck, I teleported. Shit. Bibs. Not complaining. You know what? While we're here, let's just solidify our alibi. Let's go in the hotel as well. If there's no one around the supermarket, there's no one to solidify our alibi anyway. Let's talk to the gentleman of darkness.
What happened, sinner?
What business hath you with me, human?
Stay back.
I apologize, but I have no time to spare for you. Instead, I shall let you in on something interesting. So you have no time to spare for me. But you're going to spend the time to tell me something interesting. Okay. So does he have time to spare or not? Which is it?
Fine.
Behold, that so-called arcade game. Despite your lowly intellect, you humans attempt to create worlds within games, but... How humorous. How pitiful. Well, at least I don't create games within my own mind. Unless I'm within reality. You, my friends, are not.
Listen well.
You human behave like gods in your fictional world. That act alone is an imitation of us. You? Because...
Taste your powerlessness!
The reality you humans cling to and believe to be real is merely one of the countless board games we own. What happened? Are you speechless before the truth? Have you been reading that... Lovecraft thing with Cthulhu and stuff? Because I haven't read it, but sound like you're into that sort of shit. I wasted my time. Nope. You've got your alibi. Go up to the kitchen, mess it up a little bit. Drop a glass. It's always good. Drop a glass, clean it up, leave some shards on the floor, accidentally. Why were you out so long? Drop the glass. Didn't want anyone to get injured the next day. Horrible! Ibuki is experiencing just awful Kumahara. What the fuck is a Kumahara? Kumahara? Monokuma's harassment, aka Kumahara. That's generalization. I find that offensive. Thanks to Monokuma's announcement, I completely forgot the phrase I thought up. And it was the best phrase of all time, too. It would have filled you with chills. This is a big loss for humanity as well. So you gotta act sadder. My stomach is hurting, so I can't exactly act very well now, Ibuki. And I'm still hungry, but I can't eat the chilliness. I just can't. But if I don't finish this chili, I am not a man. I am not a fish. I am a man. I'm not a fish. Sorry for your loss.
So cruel!
What's with the question mark?
Aww.
Not just Kumahara, but Hajihara. Ibuki can't stand and more. The Harahara is overwhelming me. Did you just refer to yourself in the third person? I'm gonna go pout in bed. I don't know whether to regret not spending more time with her, or to be kind of like, the fuck. Hajihara, does that mean Hajime's harassment? Yes. Yes, it does. Hey, boobs.
Yo.
Yo, Hajime, you look bored. Wanna fight me? This is the thing with martial arts, right? You're supposed to respect yourself and the opponent. So if they're going all out, not going all out is technically disrespecting them, but using reckless force or too much is sort of not respecting yourself, is it? Well, I guess in the sense if you're holding back on someone because of their gender, you're disrespecting them because of their gender. But if you're matching their fighting ability, regardless of gender, that's technically respecting them. If you just sort of go 5-10% more than they can handle, that way you're sort of pushing them. That's a good way to do it. I'll remember that for next time. What's with you all of a sudden?
Huh?
Huh? There's nothing wrong. Normally when you're bored, you fight, right? Well, not when I'm bored, but when I'm in the mood. If you can put me in the mood to fight, fight you. Except, boobs put him in the mood for something else. It's not helping. Might be a little awkward to move around. There's no way I'd consider that normal. We've got some sort of preconceived conception of what normality is. So sorry that we don't all conform to your preconceived notion of normality, Hajime Hinata. I was bored too, but since there's no people to fight, I was checking out the cottages of the Fallen. The Fallen? You mean Byaku and Teru Teru? Why?
You.
Well, someone might mess with their rooms if we just leave them alone, right? There's no way anyone would do something like that.
It's not like that.
But their rooms were locked all tight, so I couldn't go in. They were locked?
Yo.
Yeah, it turns out Monokuma locked them.
Like?
I tried to open the door, he just showed up out of nowhere, as usual. He was saying stuff like, that chapter's already finished, so it'd be complicated the game, and... Hold on, I think it's best if you don't say anything more. Oh, really? Then I should go to bed soon. Breaking the fourth wall, huh? I like it. See you later, Hajime. She's a cool chick. I like her. It's weird, right? She's a sort of cool chick. She fights, she eats, all this sort of cool stuff. I mean, typical stuff that I sort of do. So we would sort of be able to relate on those sort of things, you know? We would get along. But for some strange reason, I'd never ask a girl out like that. Not that... You know, it's not like, oh, I don't like you because of these elements of your personality. No, I like those elements of the personality, but it's not those elements that make a person interesting for me. It's differences. So it's important to have similarities, but there need to be a few fundamental differences so that the relationship is sort of balanced, that you're sort of getting access to something you otherwise would not, and that way, when you spend time together, you're sort of sharing experiences and knowledge with each other, so in the long term, you can sort of date. Whereas if you're completely similar, you'll sort of be mirrors of each other. Or if you spend too much time together, you'll start sort of morphing into sort of one type of being, which kind of becomes awkward. So you have to, in a way, be unified, yet be individual at the same time. And having key differences enables this. So, you know, if she's always training, eating, and in the mood for a little something-something, we'd be spending too much time together. I mean, yeah, your partner should be your best friend, definitely, but you need some alone time, otherwise, you two become clones of each other, and that shit's just creepy. Alright, off to the park we go. We're getting into so much trouble for this. So here I am. Game turns out to be dangerous, I'll just stop playing it. So I should just go for it. I'm willing to bet 10 Kuma coins. When he finishes playing the game, he's gonna turn around, there's gonna be... I wouldn't say one person, I'd say two people. I'd say two. The hell of it. Two. Why not? Yep. That chili's worked my stomach. It's gonna be painful. I guess for now I should try playing it a little. Can I at least play it, please? I cautiously stood in front of the arcade game. Give me a go, please. And the screen automatically lit up. As I faced the screen, I put my hand on the joystick. Oh, here we go. Monokuma Soft, licensed Monokuma Inc., Danganronpa. I love that shit. Warning, this game is work of non-fiction. Any resemblances to real persons living or dead is purely intentional. Investigation Edition. I love this. This game has a strange old-fashioned vibe to it. I wonder, is the person who's controlling Monokuma actually pretty old? Oh well, I should try to start it up. I'll press start. I'll start if I press the escape key, right? Now then, let's begin Twilight Syndrome Murder Case. Press the S key with your own hands. Hit. I pressed the S key, didn't work. Esk. Fuck it. Left click works. Second day. What? What? Ah, it's already late. I'm gonna be late for our meeting. Everyone's waiting. I gotta hurry and go. If I'm late, everyone's gonna hate me. They're waiting in classroom 1A. Can I jump? Operation room. Check it. Gotta hurry over to classroom 1A. Okay, so I can't do much. 1A, huh? I wanna see what's at the end of this hallway. I'm one of those guys that when I play a game, I always try to see what the limit is. I never really care about the direction. It's like Sundress Simulator. By the way, I played it a few times, I just haven't uploaded videos. I want to play a lot of games and upload because I'm having a lot of fun doing this, especially when people comment. Comments are cool. By the way, guys, if you're up to this far in a film, I mean video, do me a favor and like it. It really does help. Like, please. Please. Pee-pee-pees with a Goomba on top. I try to be cute. It's hard for me to be cute. I'm never cute. I'm not cute and fluffy and all that shit. Okay, here we go. Man, you're finally here. You're so late. What were you doing? Playing with myself. I'm sorry. If you're angry, I'm so sorry. Don't be mad. We're not angry. Just hurry and get over here. Okay. I should go talk to Girl B for now. Oh, what the fuck? I'm gonna get murdered, aren't I? Is it because I'm the only one with black hair? You really, never mind. Are you in good spirits today? I should talk to Girl B first. The little one's in charge, huh? We got a Dragon Ball Z vibe for you. We're here because you had something important to say, right? What's this about? Obviously it's about yesterday's incident. Was it the single most tragic event in human history? Hey, you already saw the newspaper, right? Yeah. Huh? What newspaper? God, you're such a slowpoke. In today's news... It's in today's evening newspaper. This one. Here you go. Just read it. I cannot flip my head like that. It hurts. July 8th at around 6 a.m., a janitor from XX Academy came to work. Sounds like a porno, but okay. And discovered the body of a female high school student in the music room on the second floor. Fun. The student had been struck forcefully in the head with a blunt object and was already dead. So all these girls are gonna frame this girl, huh? It seems the killer broke a window to escape. Based on the details of the crime, authorities say the investigation is ongoing and believe someone may have snuck into the school to commit the act. I was a little surprised and never expected it would make the newspaper. It says someone may have snuck into the school, so they might be thinking that a pervert did it. Okay. It is the only lead they have. I mean, her school swimsuit did get stolen too. This is definitely Andre Simulator. That sick, twisted bastard. Sneaking into a school to steal a swimsuit, killing a nearby girl, and escaping out the window. So you went to steal a swimsuit, and then you killed someone. You do realize you can buy schoolgirl swimsuits in Japan from vending machines, right? Wow, we're all in danger too. But is this really okay? We were the first ones to discover the body and we kept it a secret. It would have been the same no matter who found the body first. Don't worry about it. It's not like we have anything to hide anyway. That's right, all we did was find a body and not report it. Yeah, sure. You found a corpse and did not report it to the authorities. Let me guess, when they start asking around, you'll say I knew nothing about this. So you will then lie to the authorities about an ongoing police investigation, which will later end up biting you in the ass, making you look more suspicious, blah blah blah. At the very least, they're gonna write your name down for future reference. Nice work, girls. Nice work. That's not really a crime. Yes it is. But still, I know you're such a masochist, but there's no way I'm going to get involved in this. See? No decency. I'm finally a student at this academy. There's no way I'm getting expelled over something like this. Right. Isn't that right, Goldie? They even refer to themselves as girls. Yeah, I agree, but... what's up? You don't seem so sure. I actually have something to discuss with you guys. Goldie, I wonder what's going on. What does she want to talk about? Okay, talk. To be honest, I ended up taking several photos of her yesterday. Why? Are you talking about a body? I thought we might get questioned by the police, so I thought I should take them just in case. Why? Where are those photos now? I have them, right here. Okay, listen to me very carefully, girl. Did you or did you not have your GPS locator on when you took the photos? Because 9 times out of 10 when people get caught, they left the GPS on their phone when they took the photo. That's how they busted a bunch of cops selling drugs to criminals. I know, right? Cops got busted because they had their GPS on their phones. Work phones, mind you, when they took photos of drugs. Why your work phone? I don't want to look at them. We're definitely going to get cursed. Cursed? Stupid, curses aren't even real. You're not real. You seriously need to throw away those photos. Give them to me. Hey. This is bad. If you rip it up like that, the curse... I just said curses don't exist. It's better to just rip these photos to shreds and throw them back into the incinerator. Photos, incinerator, Yandere simulator. That's cool. I thought your photos were digital on your phone. Where did you print them? Goldie, if you have any digital copies, you need to erase those too. You can't just erase them, you have to put a file over them, otherwise it's still recoverable, and even then you should burn the phone.
Okay.
What happened? Why do you sound so desperate? Never mind, let's just forget about the whole incident. Anne is the girl that did the murder. We had nothing to do with it, and we weren't the first ones to discover the body. Okay, the end. Seriously, let's just go home already. Come on, it's getting late. Fourth day. Okay, seriously, do I have to play this game? It's getting boring, no one's dying. Man, it's already late. The hardest part of being in the archery club is changing clothes. Everyone's probably gone back by now. Then I guess I have to go back on my own. I think this is around the time that incident occurred too. Ah, jeez, why am I thinking about something so stupid again? That's right, I just gotta hurry up and forget about that incident. I won't let you forget. Well, Marowak's mother is having her revenge. Huh? Why did it go yellow? Is that my sanity meter? I won't let you forget. Who's there? Where are you?
I won't let you forget. I won't let you forget. I won't let you forget.
Forgive me.
Forgive me!
Never. Never, 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 never.
That is such a Monokuma thing.
I will never forgive you.
And now they roll the credits.
Oh, God.
Girl A. What happened? Did something happen? This is bad. This is really bad. Her head is split open like that one time. It's probably the curse. It's the curse. It's all the curse's fault. Because of the curse. What happened to girl E? Take a look in there, classroom 1B. Clutter, clutter, clutter. Wait, is that a real life picture? Game over. Down 5. What? The fuck? Huh? This is the end? Wait, now it's game over for some odd reason? I always get suspicious when I play this game, so I always check behind me and shit. Even though I should probably just look at the camera and do that. Instead of looking behind me, that wouldn't help. If there is someone behind me and I die, know that I went out playing Danganronpa. I never got to watch the anime. That would fucking suck. I don't get it. Even the game structure doesn't make sense. It started with the second day all of a sudden and jumped to the fourth day afterwards. Why are the first and third day skipped? Because no one died on the first and third day, remember? And what's this down 5 message on the game over screen? Down 5? Who's down by 5? You're down by 5 points because you haven't got laid yet. What the heck is this? I don't get this at all. How could this be a motive? Is this what it's like to play a creepy game? I wouldn't know. I don't play creepy games. Like Amnesia. Watch it. For now, it's a waste of time. Just to stay here, so I should go back to my cottage and think about it. How the fuck is this a motive? I went back to my cottage feeling hazy and disoriented. And as I tried to think about why I felt so... Oh, that's probably the garbage man. On a Sunday. I fell asleep without realizing it. Here we go, Monochrome of Theodore. This is my favorite part of the day.
Hey,
life isn't just about moving forward. When confronted by an important question, it's good to stop moving and take your time thinking about it. For example, my stomach hasn't felt well all morning, so I ran to the restroom as soon as I got off the train. While right now I was about to enter, an important question stood before me. Life is like that. Every now and then, suddenly an important question gets in your way. The important question that stood before me was the gentleman sign on the restroom door. As I resisted the overwhelming urge to poop, I thought about it desperately. Am I really a gentleman? Do I have class? Am I honest? Am I faithful? No. Why am I even hesitating? Of course I'm a gentleman. A regular person wouldn't last 5 minutes resisting this urge to poop, but a gentleman most certainly would. I resisted for about 10 minutes. Filled with pride, I ran into the restroom, went for gentlemen, and what awaited me was another important question. The important question that stood before me was the Western style and Japanese style signs on each door. I was definitely born in Japan, but haven't I forgotten what makes clean, beautiful Japan so good? Do I have enough confidence in myself to take a Japanese style poop? As you see, there are always important questions waiting for you.
Brought to you by Monokuma.
That's what life is all about. You know, sitting on a toilet seat isn't actually the best way to poop, just because the way you're sitting does not allow the body to sort of clean. If you're sort of squatting, it allows the body to sort of poop. So, the best position to be in when pooping is squatting. In case you were wondering.
Ahem! Hope's Peak Academy School Trip Executive Committee has an announcement to make!
Oh, I was gonna say important announcement to make.
Good morning, everyone! Looks like today is gonna be another perfect tropical day! Now then, let's show some enthusiasm and make sure to give it our all today!
I've almost got his lip syncing, but did Monokuma get fatter? Morning, huh? In the end, the game is still a mystery. I don't even know why it would be a motive. I should just bite the bullet and try discussing it with everyone. Guess I should head over to the restaurant. I don't think we should be walking up to everyone and saying we played the game. Even though I suspect half the fucking idiots in this place will admit to doing it. I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't. You're gonna lose so much of your goddamn credibility. Oh, Hibuki. Oh. Mikan, why the hell are you always, like, sad? Hi, Mikan.
Hello.
Oh, hiyo gozaimasu. It's such a nice day today. I'm so glad it's sunny. I mean, if it wasn't sunny, it'd be a waste. Huh? Waste? It's nothing. I'm only mumbling to myself just now. So I'll excuse myself first. Waste, what the hell is going on? I don't know, man. I don't know. I don't understand half these women.
Poke, poke, poke!
What are you groaning about?
Why, you!
Ibuki isn't groaning for some gross reason like Nakamura does. I'm worried about a more sublime, a more serious matter. And that matter is...
Yes!
Ibuki's music genre from now on. Music genre? I escaped the pop sounds of the girl band genre, so I'm thinking about changing my music stylings completely. Ah, I see. But there's nothing that comes to mind. This is very troubling.
Meow.
Hajime, if you think of anything, I look forward to hearing your advice. Well, you've got the whole scene thing going, so, you know. But is that something you can really decide on a whim? Sure, some of the best decisions are decided on a whim. Like, will you marry me? You literally give the girl 10 seconds to decide. Even though she's thought about it for ages beforehand. It's awkward when she says no. It's called awkward for everyone, I think. I'm half tempted to just chat to these people without reading anything just for XP. Especially since the little psycho girl, I don't actually feel like taking on a date. She's not my type of psycho. Cruelty to animals is not my type of psycho. Cruelty to people is my type of psycho. Good morning, Hyoko.
Hey, hey!
Doesn't Chika get bored of playing the same game over and over? Don't you get bored of killing animals over and over? She's not going to reply to my greetings, is she? I don't understand gamers at all. Hey! In fact, I don't even want to understand them. Well, fuck you too. Seriously, everyone here is such a weirdo. Except Mahiru.
Jeez!
When I'm with you guys, I feel like I'm gonna become a weirdo too. Too late for that one, honey. Feel like you already are one. High five, Hajime. Bam! Chiaki! Good morning.
Hey.
Good morning, Hajime. It's rare for you to reply so quickly in the morning.
Yep.
Yeah, I just finished playing a game right now.
Hey.
More importantly, I was just wondering, is someone bringing food to Nagito? I brought him food yesterday morning. I don't know about the others. Is it alright if I see how he's doing later? I'll head over to the restaurant for now. Sure, you just do your thing. Oh, by the way, what the fuck happens with these levels? Do I get anything for them? Like, oh yeah, I get experience, right? I get level points? I must have a lot of level points.
Good day.
Good morning, Hajime. Yeah, good morning. The fuck is this, a harem? Every girl's saying hello to me. Every guy's shit at picking up girls. Oh god, it is one, isn't it? After greeting everyone, I put some food on my plate and sat myself at a table near the window.
Yo!
What is it, Hajime? Is that all you're gonna eat? I'm not gonna say something wildly inappropriate. You just eat too much, Akine.
You
don't want to talk. All you eat is candy.
Why?
Just because it's candy doesn't mean you should make fun of it. These gummies have 4 different fruit flavors, so I'm sure they're full of nutrients. Is she even a legal teenager?
Like?
You should just eat real fruit. It seems like a bad time to bring up that game all of a sudden. No. There is no good time to bring up that game. I mean, we did agree before we shouldn't even play it. Exactly!
Let me tell you this.
Is Mahiru missing? Huh? After Gundam said that, I looked around the restaurant. And sure enough, there was no sign of Mahiru. She's always here, every morning. It's strange for her not to come. I wonder if she's not feeling well.
Maybe.
If she just doesn't feel well, that's fine, but there's a small chance that she's...
What the?
A small chance she's what? I saw Mahiru, she was outside the hotel. Oh, I see.
Jeez,
don't just say a spooky thing.
Let's go!
As punishment, how about you run around in a circle 3 times, say woof, and jump off a cliff. Children these days are creepy. I don't want to die like that.
Hey, hey!
But what was Mahiru doing outside the hotel?
Yo!
She said she wanted to be alone. I even asked her to come eat with us, but she turned it down.
What?
Wanted to be alone? Maybe she's planning to play that game.
Shut up!
What are you saying, pig barf? There's There's no way Mahito would play video games. She's not like that slowpoke gamer girl over there. That slowpoke gamer girl has got 6 points.
Does she?
What points does she have? Hikai. 2. She's got more points than you, miss. What's your name again? Hyoko? Well, Hyoko? Not even on this list. You're doing well for a girl, aren't you?
Huh?
Huh? Are you referring to me? I am a pig barf, aren't I? Looks like it's going to be impossible to start talking about the game. How about we don't talk about the game? How about that? And while I was lost in thought, someone quickly sat down across from me at the table.
Yo!
Hey Hajime, got a second? Great. He's gonna call dibs on one, isn't he? What is it? Kazuichi leaned forward, out of his seat, glanced quickly around the room, and whispered to me.
Yeah.
Today, 2:30, come to the supermarket. That's some creepy shit. But don't tell anyone else about it. Sure. I'm gonna come to the supermarket at 2:30, all by myself. Huh? I'll tell you the details later. Everyone else can see us right now. It's bad.
Wow. I'm yawning.
Ugh. I'm probably gonna take a little break sometime during this game, sleep, and then continue on. Even though I'm only level 101 in World of Warcraft Legion. And I need to make guides. Yeah, Danganronpa. I'll play some Danganronpa. What does he mean, it's bad?
You fiend.
Hey, what are you lowly creatures discussing amongst yourselves?
Well...
Oh, nothing. You know, lowly peasant stuff. Insignificant to you, Overlord. It's got nothing to do with you, so just relax and go away. You think I was worried about you fiends? Exactly. You make me laugh, I say. Laugh! You've elevated arrogance to an art form.
Shiver!
What sort of supreme ruler feels concerned for the ants who are destined to be crushed?
My name is Gundam Tanaka!
I am the forbidden ruler who makes even the gods of darkness flee in terror. I don't even know what to say anymore.
Fall, my tears.
All I desire is silence and indifference. Silence and indifference. And hamsters. I never took him for the lonely type. Really? Never took him. The lonely type. I'm gonna open the door so I get some air in the room. Maybe the lack of oxygen is killing me. I sincerely hope it's just the lack of oxygen. Maybe it's the fact that I slept 2 hours yesterday. 3 hours the day before that. And only a few hours the day before that. So, should technically be pretty tired.
For now.
Anyway, Hajime, that's what's happening, so I'll see you then.
You know, right?
Just so, you know, make sure you conserve your energy. Do not want to have gay sex with you in the supermarket. Just putting it out there. Huh? Conserve my energy? I'll see you later. What the fuck was all that about? Instead of talking about games, I received a strange request from Kazuichi. And that day's breakfast came to an end. Oh, I'm back in my room. It's good. Free time, please. Kazuichi told me to go to the supermarket at 2:30 p.m. But what did he mean when he told me to conserve my energy? Well, I guess I shouldn't wander too far right now. Oh my god, free time. Okay, we've got some free time. Let's check if we've got all the inventory we need to go on another date. Okay, so we've got 2 presents that could work. That is good. Okay. I was gonna go to sleep, but I do not want to ruin this opportunity to spend some free time with our favorite gamer, who just so happens not to be here. Okay, where the hell is she? Please tell me she didn't go to Nagito. Okay, Sonya, I would totally on a normal day hit that, but right now I'm looking for Gamer Girl. Tell me she is not at Nagito's. Tell me she she is not at Nagito's. Nagito's tied up beyond this point, but I don't want to see him right now. I'm not mentally prepared for it. I shouldn't go inside. And no Usami to stop me. Huh. It's new. Oh, Chika's in a room. That's cool. That is cool. Where's everyone else? I was playing the game. Like quite literally, where is everyone else? I literally cannot find the other people. They're not on the map. Where's the crazy girl? One island, two island. But literally, no one here. Oh wait, most of them are here. What? Oh, okay. And the rest are missing. The rest are AWOL. So one here, one here. Four there. None here. None here. None here. None here. Can I go here? It's so weird, man. I can't get off the island. For some reason, there's a few people missing, and I cannot port to where the island and the game is. So I can't talk to Pekko or any of the other missing people. I'm just gonna talk to Chikai. Who is it? Me. Oh, we're going in a room. Well, that's sweet. You got your own Monokuma arcade machine. What the fuck is this? Is this a new game that just came out? DSO PSP. Huh. And there's always that upskirt panty shot. Because, you know, why not? Pretty sure I'm going to regret playing this, but that's what makes it so much fun. Huh. Well, you've got like controllers to every single your PlayStation 2, got your Dreamcast, got your Sega, and I'm missing one. Well, that's Nintendo 64, so you got your PlayStation, you've got your GameCube, got your Dreamcast, and then you've got your Sega. Gotcha. Alright, is there a Monokuma around here? Oh my god, chips, soft drink, and books. You are truly interesting. I don't want to spend that much energy today. I think I'd rather sit still and read a book or something. Should I do? Should I hang out with Chikai? Yes. Yes, you should.
Hey, hey.
You want to read too? Let's go to the library together. I thought we could play some co-op, but okay. I spent time today reading with Chikai. The Kaman Sutra. Looks like Chikai and I grew a little closer. It's not the only thing that grew today. Of course, I'd like to give her a present. I will give her the Power Gauntlet. A video game controller shaped like a glove. Use your fingers to play games, but it is not compatible with modern game consoles. Diehard fans love how bad this thing is. Not compatible with modern game consoles? Fair enough. Hajime, you seem to be holding something pretty nice. Yeah, aren't I?
Thanks.
Thank you, no one has ever given me such an awesome present before. And she smiled. God damn it, this mushy mushy shit is getting to me.
Hey, hey.
Hey, hey, where do you want to go today? It's kind of fun that we go and hang out, and then we go somewhere to do an adventure. That is cool. This is the first time I've seen Chikai look so interested. And she's not even sleeping. Maybe she was looking forward to this. I don't know, man. I don't know. Let's see, why don't we go check out the storage room in the old building? We might find something interesting. That is so not classy, but okay.
Yep.
Like Shokoban? It's a fun game to play. It's this old puzzle game where you have to push boxes in a warehouse to find their assigned spots. Oh, see.
Let's go.
And let's win over Monami so we can go inside the storage room. Please don't have your first time in the storage room. That shit's not classy. Chikai pumped herself up, and after winning over Monami, we went into the storage room. Together. And Monami did not try to stop us. She just looked me straight in the eye, pulled out a little rabbit paw, and said, "Here, take this." There's not a whole lot you can push and pull. Yeah. Don't tell me you were serious about playing Shokubine in the storage room. By all means, push and pull away. No wonder she seems so excited about coming here.
Hey.
Hey, Hajime, are you good at puzzle games? I wouldn't say I'm bad at them. Nah, I'm not that good at using my brain. Sure.
You think so?
Huh, really? Maybe you just don't like them because you haven't played that many.
Well?
You know how to properly theorize in order to view things, and you can calmly manage when it's important. I feel like you'd be good at puzzle games once you got the hang of it. Okay? Huh? You really see me like that? Kind of embarrasses me.
See?
Embarrasses me too. For example, Rubik's Cube and Jigsaw puzzles are puzzle games too. Oh yeah, I remember putting together a lot of Jigsaw puzzles when I was little.
See?
Yep, then you already know the trick, right? The trick to Jigsaw puzzles. Outer pieces. You assemble from the outer pieces, right?
Yep.
That's right. First, you separate the pieces with edges. Afterwards, you separate the leftovers by color. It makes putting it together a lot easier. I see. Now I kind of feel like putting one together since it's been such a long time. That reminds me, my father always programmed puzzle games. Your father is a programmer?
Yep.
Apparently, he was pretty manly when he was focusing in front of his laptop. Apparently? Yep. Gonna need a drink first. Okay, my shoulder's free. Cry away. But I heard he couldn't solve a puzzle he made, and it really depressed him. But since he hated losing, he actually went out of his way to write a separate program, and then he made the program do stuff like brute force attack. Brute force what? She'll explain it. Oh my god, that is so cute. It's a way of forcibly finding the answer. No worries though, it's normal for you not to know. I don't really understand, but it seems like Chikai also knows about programming. Okay, essentially brute force works by trying every possible combination. It's only a matter of time. For example, if your password is only numbers, and say it is up to 10 digits, it's just going to start at 00000, 00001, 00002, until eventually just hits all nines. Eventually, it will get it correct. But more importantly, what does everyone say about her father sound like hearsay? Wouldn't that mean she didn't personally see it? Yes, that is what it would mean. She lacks a father figure, which is why she goes to you as a sort of caregiver and a guide. Don't fuck up.
Hey.
We should get going and head back. Yeah, you're right.
Huh?
What the? Whoa. That's a little sudden, isn't it? It's unexpected. Huh? I quickly opened my arms and caught Chikai as she fell into them. Are you okay?
Thanks.
How embarrassing. I've never tripped before in my life. Point. And I love how Naigi's on minus one. He's not even in the game. Just fuck Naigi. This guy is doing a lot better than Naigi. As she said that, she stepped away from my chest. My heart sounds really loud. Of course it does. It's my heart. That surprised me. You're pretty hard, Hajime. We've got a Sayaka incident here. Monokuma, don't do this again. You're a dick. And Usami, you just shut up. Huh? That is... Unlike me, your arms and chest are really built. You're definitely a boy. Why, thank you. Oh, that's what you meant. Yeah, that's obvious. I'm glad you caught me. That means I'll be fine in case of emergencies. That's right, that's right. Reliable.
Sleepy.
Even if I suddenly get sleepy, I'll be fine. You can carry me. Son of a bitch. Manipulation. You girls are just... whatever. Just carry her. I've actually done that a few times. To carry a girl. Just fell asleep on the couch and I'm just like, fuck. Hey, don't sleep! Oh, come on, dude! Just carry her back! Be romantic as fuck about it, dude. I desperately tried to keep Chikai from falling asleep and walked her back to her room. Just carry her! Checked out your chest, checked out your arms. Use them. Why else would you lift weights? If you're not lifting weights to lift shit, why are you lifting them? Looks like it's almost time to meet up with Kazuichi. He told me to come to the supermarket. What's he thinking all of a sudden? And keeping it a secret from the others. I don't want to think about it, but if he's plotting to... No, there's no way someone as carefree as him would do something like that. What? I don't even have a choice in the matter, do I? We just turn up. I don't like this. You get whacked over the head. Huh? It's well past the arranged time and there's no sign of Kazuichi. Of course, it's set up. All of a sudden, the anxiety level I've been keeping inside me began to swell up like a balloon until... Yo. What?
Whoa!
Okay.
Hey!
What the heck? Don't get all pissed just because I was a little late. Late? Oh, I get it. I totally forgot he's that kind of guy. A guy who doesn't mind showing up late even though he's the one who asked me to come. That kind of guy. Well, sometimes coming late isn't a bad thing. No? Okay. Well, sort of makes sense. So what do you want? Why'd you call me out here like this?
Hey.
Well, you know, can you do me a little favor? Let me guess, you want me to put a good word in with Sonya? A little favor? I just overheard something. Apparently it's Miss Sonya's idea for a change of pace. Like the girls are secretly planning to go splash around at the beach. And you want to go peeking. Doesn't seem so secret now, does it? Wait, don't tell me you... As expected of Miss Sonya, splashing around in the sea is a nice idea. I admire so much it's shocking. My heart trembles around her so much it's about to burn out. So, let's crash it together. I'll do it. Yeah, fuck, I'll do it. Wait, Chikai's gonna be there. Oh, fuck. If Peko and Chikai are there, we might have a little bit of a problem. Houston, I got a problem. Why me?
Hey, hey!
Well, it's weird to fake a coincidence all by itself, isn't it? It's true. We can always say we were going out for a romantic swim. As your pink hair reminded me of... That other girl with pink hair. So how about a scenario when you and I go to the beach and then we run into the girls by coincidence? Now you're thinking. Sorry girls, guys do shit like this all the time. And you girls probably know we do shit like this all the time. But you'd let us pretend like you don't know that we're doing this shit. And we let you pretend like we don't know that you didn't read our messages. Since Facebook made that little scene thing, you girls are out of luck. Even though you can read them without that little scene thing popping up. I love that whole waiting game girls play. What they don't realize is, it's not that difficult to play it. And then they start responding really quickly, and then they get pissed off when you don't respond instantly. So you can play that game, girl. Trust me.
Huh?
Hey, you better not say no. I can't ask any of the other guys to help me with this. And a cool thing that I like to do, if you ever have to do that, just reply while you're playing a video game. So for example, you're playing an FPS. Every time you die, you can reply, or I don't know, if you're playing Danganronpa, for example, every like 30, 40 minutes or like a section, you can reply. I was like, what the fuck's he doing? It must be someone else. You might be talking to other girls. Now, just playing video games. I don't give a fuck.
Man.
Ikemura can't keep his mouth shut to save his life. The Gundam as well. Gundam. For Yuhiko and Naigito are out of the question. I understand where you're coming from, but I don't feel like going to the beach. Hey, I took the time to prepare your swimsuit, you know? Now you're just gonna walk all over my kind act? Snapping at me? If you say no, I'm gonna bug you about it until you die. Fortunately, I believe that. I look emo enough to come back from the dead anyway. There's no way he's joking about that. This is Kazuichi after all. If I have no choice, then fine. Ooh, that's my Hajime. That's how a soul brother should act. We're not doing that Mondo Taka crap, man. We're not doing crazy shit in that sauna, man. I'm not into that shit. What do I have to do?
Well,
based on what I overheard, it looks like they're going to the Chandler Beach on the second island.
All right.
That's why we gotta head over there to that diner first. Our plan is to be at the beach before they get there. And we're gonna act like it's just a coincidence? Got it. So I need to go to the diner. Woo, I'm getting all excited now. So you're just gonna be at the beach beforehand, just chilling. Two guys, by themselves, at the beach. Not inviting any girls. Yeah, I can see that working. Well, that makes one of us, I suppose. Looks like you can't take a hint. Can we go now? Leave here? Yes. This is gonna be fun. I'm just gonna run there, because my avatar needs the exercise. Wait, the fuck? What the hell is he doing here? He was just in the supermarket. Ah, fuck it.
For now.
Looks like they're going to the Chandler Beach on the second island.
Alright!
So we're gonna head over there to the diner first. Our plan is to meet them at the beach before they get there. Okay, how the hell are you teleporting in front of me? Are you like, Hiro and have the power of marijuana? I already told you, all I want is silence and indifference. I see. Huh? Hey, Hajime, it's all good, so let's hurry up and go. Oh, God. Looks so lonely. If you want to hang out, just say so. Maybe he's just lonely. Maybe he's going crazy from all the loneliness. Just, dude. Just, like, say something. I'll be a friend. Just, like, maybe tone it down on the whole taking over the world shit. It's old after high school, dude. We all want to take over the world. Oh, come on. Quit teleporting, you lazy fuck. Stupid guy doesn't even run. Yay, Monokuma Burgers. Let me guess, the Yakuza kid's gonna be here. It's like that's what he does. We're at the diner. Okay, here we go. Here we go. We're at the diner. Okay, we're at the diner. Alright, we're here. Now we just have to stake out a spot and wait until the ladies arrive. You sure about this plan? I mean, isn't this a little too stalkerish?
Hey,
where do you think you're going? Like I said, we have to wait here and stake it out until the ladies arrive. Fine, I'll be your stalker buddy. One thing I don't understand is, where's the benefit of feeding my pet with hope? How do I get my pet hope? I can give it this rain shit, can't I? We stop badges and these broken wands. I don't want to use them though. Let's just do this shit. Alright, let's just look at the girls. Let's just do this. And when are they gonna come? Did you happen to overhear that in your sensitive ears too? They mentioned something about coming a little after that sun starts to tilt, so maybe around 4 p.m. It's 3 p.m. right now, so we have to wait one more hour? Always make you move early. It's just the basics, you know. I'm getting a coffee. You asshole. Got an hour to kill. Do whatever the fuck I want. You know, while I was having my coffee, my iced coffee, which I used actual spoons to put coffee in instead of teaspoons because caffeine does fuck all to me now. I'm essentially immune to it. I figured out that myself and Soda being the only two guys here poses a problem. If it's a coincidence, you need more than two people. And having this guy, who's drooling over Sonya the entire time, And having Hajime that's hitting on 2-3 girls at the same time doesn't tilt the odds in our favor. It makes it look like we're peaking. We need someone that would never do that. Like Gundam. He would have been perfect for this. Ay. And at the very least, you could have just brought the guy along for Christ's sake. Ugh, goddammit. Hey, I don't know if I should be talking like an expert right now.
Hey.
It's fine. Just make sure you keep watch by the window. It'd be bad if you didn't catch Miss Sonya on her way to the beach, you know? It's our job to keep that from happening. To get to the beach, they gotta pass in front of the diner.
Engine's revving.
You better keep your eyes peeled. This isn't a game. Wait, so you're gonna let them pass through first, and then you're gonna rush past them? If there's only one way to the beach, shouldn't we be there now? This isn't a game, then what is it? I really should have just said no. Sitting at a table by the window, I rested my chin in my hands and absent-mindedly stared out the window. Are they coming? Did they arrive? It hasn't even been 10 minutes yet. 20 minutes passed and then 30. As the time passed, the only things that grew were the volume of my sighs and the weight of my regrets. Say, what kind of swimsuits do you think Miss Sonya will wear? Since she's a foreigner, how about a bikini? Maybe she won't wear one at all. Maybe she's that type of foreigner. Don't you feel like there's a pure, innocent, mythical fantasy between the top and the bottom of a bikini? No, I don't. I never thought about it that much, to be honest. I'm not a beach person. Even if I wanted to agree with you, I don't know how to answer that. Wait, huh? And that's when it happened. In the corner of my eye, a certain someone walked past the front of the diner. Yakuza kid.
Huh?
I wonder what happened. I guess I should head over. We left the diner in a hurry and ran to where the person was standing. Who is that person? Who is the person? Knew it!
What?
You bastards! What? I knew it was you. Were you Hiko? What are you doing here?
Shut the hell up!
That's my line!
Hey!
What the heck? You're awfully tense. Actually, why do you seem so flustered? Who are you calling flustered? Don't go making false accusations, you bastard!
Huh?
And tell me. Oh man, is that it? You overheard my plan, didn't you? This is not gonna help. We've got the three most perverted people in the fucking group. Look, we seriously gotta get our asses back to the hotel and at least pick up Gundam. At the very least. Wait, that's even more suspicious. Where the fuck would the four of us be hanging out together? Why would the Yakuza kid be hanging out with anybody? This is not gonna end well, man. Like, this is not good.
Huh?
Plan?
Huh?
It's no use playing dumb. You have heard my plan and follow us all the way here, right?
Hello!
Hey, what are you doing at this place? Play. It. Cool. Ibuki is one of the coolest chicks here. Play it cool. Say you felt like a burger and headed there with soda. And then you found this little Yakuza kid because they felt like a burger. Or say it was a nice hot day and you felt like going for a burger. And then you decided to go on the beach and had your swimsuit. Fuck, shit. You saw it was a hot day and figured you might as well go for a stroll. Possibly swim. And hope she says, oh, us too. And asks you to join. And then that photographer chick, whose name I forgot, is probably gonna say something like, ooh, be gentlemen and let us have the beach for ourselves. And I'll just be like, well, that's probably why you're all by yourself. Because you keep telling everyone to fuck off. Have to do it. Be nice to people. Cheers. Yeah. What are you doing at this place?
Oh my my!
That's a strange combo. Ah, fuck, she's already onto us.
Hello,
today's another wonderful day, well. Wait, all the girls are coming? And you just wanted to bring the two of us? How much juggling do you want me to do?
You're done for!
You're not gonna get away now that I've caught you. What? I got so nervous I ended up blurting out something weird. Cordus, you say? What do you think Cordus doing? Exactly. Two girls are onto us. Please don't help me. I'll take the punishment as much as you like. See, if Nagi was here, I'd say, hey Nagi, go with Mikan. The odds of you failing are only 20%. You should do fine.
Wow.
You two, this is such a coincidence. I never expected to coincidentally run into you guys here. Okay, stop saying coincidence so much. He really does suck at this. Yeah, he does.
Wow.
Man, actually, Hajime and I were about to head to the beach together. Why didn't Hajime do the talking?
Oh my.
Huh. Could that be what you ladies are here for? That's such a coincidence. It even seemed like destiny. Oh god. You're quite literally gonna drag me down with you. Something's obviously suspicious. Your eyes are moving around like a salmon before they lay eggs. At this point of the conversation, you could throw a curved ball. It's not a curved ball. But if it goes wrong, it would essentially be like throwing him under the bus, but you don't want to do that. If Sonya's not there, you could just say something along the lines of, Soda really wanted to go to the beach and asked if I wanted to go with him. I had nothing to do, so I said, sure, let's stop by the diner first. That way, you're sort of making it seem like, hey, he needed someone with him, but you're not making it out like, you're on a stalkerish mission. It's more like he's using you as a friend blanket. So it's less of, I'm perving on you girls, and more of, I lack the confidence to make a move on my own, but I'm being cute about it. So you could try to help him out and make him seem cute and genuine and inexperienced, because they might appreciate that, because they'll make him seem less of a creep. And hopefully shut him up from saying stupid shit.
Well.
No way, I'm always like this. How should I put it? I always pay attention to my surroundings. Hajime, take control of this conversation before he digs a hole so big that neither of us can climb out of. I can't keep watching this. Then do something about it. Grow some fucking balls. As I sighed and looked away from the embarrassing sight, I realized that he had disappeared. Wait, he's probably already at the beach. Little bastard. Huh? Where did Fuyuhiko go?
Well...
Well, regardless, you two have arrived pretty early. It's only 3:30. You still have about 30 minutes until you meet them. Fuck it. Fuck it. I got my ice cube. I need my ice cube. Cold a drink in a cold environment wakes you up, but it also drains your energy. Oh well. The only thing we can do at this point, quite literally, is to quite literally fess up. Not in the sense that we're gonna go perv on the girls. More along the lines of, hey Boogie, can I talk to you for a minute? Soda's sort of been trying to, you know, approach Sonya. But he sort of gets really nervous. And so he sort of asked me to come along, and is there any chance you can help us out? That is a lot better than, I'm here to creep on all the girls. I don't know. Options limited. You guys think that would work? Personally, I think at this point, we have to reduce the creep factor as much as possible. because at this point he is literally committing social suicide. I mean, this is a saving throw. Let's try to fucking at least throw him in a direction away from a landmine. Why do you know we're going to meet with the others? Okay, at this point, you have to bring in Mikan and Ibuki. If it's just the two of them... Shit. If you just talk to Ibuki, Mikan's gonna get more creeped out, she's gonna get the creep factor, she's gonna fess up to the other girls because she's the most likely to do so. If you tell her, and Ibuki's stuck there, she's gonna probably start poking fun at him. You should probably tell Mikan first, and then tell Ibuki, because Ibuki would be able to assess the situation a lot better than Mikan, but you have to hope that Soda doesn't totally fuck it up while you're talking to Mikan. Because telling them both at the same time would put Soda in such an awkward position that he'll start mumbling like a fucking idiot. I hope he just shuts his mouth.
Why, you?
And you even know our damn meeting time! And she's already pissed. Hajime, initiate what I said now, or you're essentially fucked. Well, you see, okay, you shut up.
For now.
Anyway, let's cherish the coincidence that brought us together, so it's okay if we join in too. I cannot even facepalm myself to this shit. And you have the audacity to wink and do a thumbs up. Hajime, are you going to do something about this, or are you just going to continue standing there and observing? So that's your ulterior motive. You're probably here for Sonya, aren't you? Yes! Now's the time to initiate, Hajime. It's perfect. She's not mad, she's just kind of... They all know about it, you fucking idiot. Just do your stupid high school shit. Just come, they'll probably help you out, you fuckwit. I really have no desire to do something so rude like decline that offer at all. Even though she's crying. Just tell them, Hajime, just do this thing once. But Sonya was the one who planned to go to the beach, so we need to ask her.
Of course.
And it's all good. It's too devastating to think Miss Sonya would decline, so I just won't think it. Soda, you and me gotta have some serious talks after this. Some serious talks. Is he being an optimist or a pessimist? I don't really get it.
Hey!
Is it alright if we go inside now? Ibuki was gonna eat a meal first. That's why I came early. Yeah, good idea. Ibuki, inside. I'll go inside too. Mikan, you go inside too. Soda, you... Bury your head in the sand for about 20 minutes. Sure thing. Let's wait inside. I can't take my mind off for Yuhiko. Oh well, I've come this far. I can't really turn back now. What have you done lately? You've done nothing. You're observing. You're a third party. You're a witness. You're fucking impartial to everything in this fucking game. Okay, Ibuki, help me out here. An army marches on its stomach, while swimmers can only splash around on their stomachs too. That's actually quite painful. I'm gonna heartily eat a hamburger with a side of rice. Would you like some curry with that? Is rice a side dish? Wait, is there even rice here? You suck with women, don't you? Mew, I always say something stupid when I get nervous. I'm not doing it on purpose. Okay, give her a break, guys. Give her a break. Okay, Soda, I'm a fucking bitch slap you right now. Alright, let's wait inside until Miss Sonya arrives. Motherfucker. I get annoyed. I returned to the diner and sat myself at the table near the window once again. Phew. Without thinking, I couldn't help let out a big sigh. Sit across from Ibuki. You've gone out with her once, maybe twice. You've got a little bit of social leverage here. Cash in. Oh, what are you guys going to do about your swimsuits? You aren't allowed to change in that beach house, you know. Shut your mouth and let the adults do the talking. Yes, that's why we're already wearing them. What's underneath this uniform isn't panties, it's a swimsuit.
Of course.
Well, that's obvious. I also came wearing a swimsuit too. This is the worst thing that's ever happened. And I've done some sketchy shit to pick up girls. I'm not telling that story. That's gonna be in my autobiography. And it's the most embarrassing thing ever. And even, like, I had worse cards than this. And I still... not say. Maybe one day. Huh, really? Which reminds me, you're not wearing yours yet, huh? Then you gotta go to the bathroom so you can change. You see, that grin and that look is the problem, buddy. You've got that look about you. What the fuck is that? What even is that? Can we stop with the thick fucking, I don't know if that's mascara or eyeliner, I don't know the difference of makeup, but can we stop with that shit? Can we just like stop for 1 minute? I mean, fine, you've got pink hair, cool. You like soda, cool. You've got a little braid, all right. It's cool in some things. You got some earrings, fine. But the makeup dude, like, I know that's the look you're going for, but it's kind of creepy. Your face is very sharp and you're going for the very look. You gotta calm the fuck down. You gotta be cool. You gotta stop being creepy. You definitely gotta do something about that jacket. I'm not a fashion expert, but look like garbage man. So here you go, this is yours. Really, dude? Can you give me a thong? What is this thing? It may be rude of me to say this, but that looks like a little too daring.
Are you serious?
What if something falls out? If this is airing live, you're totally gonna get censored by the network. Well, they've already tried to censor me on YouTube several times, but how did that work out? Why do you think I don't say things openly anymore? It takes a little bit more, you know, finesse, but... do I even know what finesse means? Am I just using words to sound more intelligent? Probably. Don't know half the words I use. Coincidentally. YouTube, please don't censor me. Don't worry, even at its worst, it won't turn into a live-action drama. You're turning this into a Korean drama with your... escapades. That's not the problem. What is it then? Are you telling me you don't want to match with me? Match with you? Are you fucking serious? It's matching? Then I definitely don't want to... I believe fighting is bad, so let's stop. Okay, at this point, the girl's already part of the scheme. And I have a feeling Ibuki's gonna bail you out, so...
Peeking.
Things are heating up something fierce. When everyone's gonna come, I hope they come soon. She's cool. She's definitely cool. I would definitely want Ibuki as a friend. Just a friend. I know, right? Guys and girls can be just friends, right? As you said that, Ibuki peeked out the window.
Oh!
Oh! What is it? Look outside! Outside! What's outside?
Isn't
what?
Hyoko?
Yes. Yes, it is. And she seems to be crying. I think the little Yakuza kid exposed himself.
Jeez, don't get my hopes up. I thought it was Miss Sonia.
Whatever.
Doesn't she seem a little strange?
No. No. Little Loli keeps killing little animals and has mummy issues with that other girl.
If I had to describe it as a song title, it'd be Sprint of Tears.
Huh? It looks like she's running from the beach. Did something happen?
Maybe someone killed her mommy. Despite our questions, Kyoko ran by the front of the diner at full speed.
Huh?
She totally ran past us, but wasn't she part of the beach crew? Apparently she can't swim, so she turned us down.
Hmm.
but she didn't just come running from the beach?
I'm sorry,
I don't know what all the details are about that. Well, it just means women are full of surprises. Women are always full of surprises. Mahita's the type to totally come, but she surprisingly turned us down too. Wait, not all the girls are coming? And we're already chatting about this. Two girls, two guys. Hey Ibuki, throw us a line here and say you invited us to the beach. And we'll walk to the supermarket to get some board shorts. Mihiru, she did? She turned it down? It's so unexpected of her not to join in an event like this. In fact, she'd totally planned this sort of thing.
That's totally it!
But it can't be helped. Apparently she wasn't really feeling well. I'm terribly sorry to continue this topic, but why was Hyoko crying? Why are you asking us? But if she was sprinting away from the beach and crying, something's definitely wrong.
Hey.
Hey.
Whoa.
When did you get here so suddenly? Kazuichi suddenly shouted, and what he was looking at was near the diner's entrance. And as I turned around...
My, my, how disappointing. I thought if I came early, I'd be the first one to arrive.
She gets a point. You're on a roll today, Chikai. You are on a roll today. Hey, man, she gets a point. I couldn't keep myself from staring like an idiot. Well, there you go.
Whoa, Chiaki, you came wearing only your swimsuit.
Chiaki? Why did I say Chikai? I can't even pronounce a name, Chiaki.
I didn't want to carry it with me. If I did, it'd be a serious burden.
Seriously? Serious burden? That's a total exaggeration.
But even though you didn't want to carry anything, it looks like you're carrying something.
Wow, I'm surprised you didn't stutter while saying that.
Instead of bringing lunch for everyone, I brought ice cream.
It's not like I'm gonna turn it down, but...
Oh god. Please don't say... You guys know what I'm thinking, right?
Ice cream is completely different from lunch. I don't think it can be used as a substitute.
Okay, they're not gonna go that route. Fair enough, I thought a little bit of, band service was in order.
Also, I was thinking of stuff we could all do at the beach together. So I brought a board game, too.
I give her an E for effort.
Hmm. Should we play it, even though we came all this way to go to the beach? Nah.
You can play it at the beach. Well, you bought the board game, you can play it at the diner. Later, before, in between, burgers. Come on, guys. Chiaki?
I see. That's disappointing.
I wouldn't say, why don't we play? That might be a little too eager. Shit, what would I say in this situation? I say something like, what board game is it? Fucking genius. Oh, what board game is it? I had no idea you guys were going to the beach. White lies. But how should I say this? Is this what Gapmo is supposed to be? Gapmo? Gapmoe? What the fuck is a Gapmoe? Gapmoe. Gapmoe is when a character does something completely contradictory to their usual habits, personality, character appearance dictates. Anime Suki user said, yup, for that gap effect to work, you have to see the person in a completely different light that you never expect. Images. This might help. Keep this chimney clean. Oh, boobs. It's always good. I guess it's a part of fan service? In a, I guess it's a uncharacteristic, what the fuck? Huh, I never really finished playing Mass Effect 2, I got stuck. Just what on earth is Gatmoe? What in the fuck? Tough Kai plus drunken boy kiss equals Gatmoe. Fuck this. Ugh, I'm back. I know I did not freak out from two guys kissing each other. I'm more freaked out because I needed the bathroom again. I'm honestly dying at this point. What men's action causes a Gatmoe feeling? Rank 1. What men's action causes a Gatmoe feeling? Sample size 698 whipping. 69, sorry. A cool and tough guy with a whimsical smile. 100. What? I have to read what Gatmoe is because this doesn't make sense. No, it's not Moe girls as seen in clothing line from The Gap. And how boring would that be? Thankfully, according to a recent survey over at What Japan Thinks, Gatmoe is described as a contradiction in exhibiting characteristics that people find cutely attractive. In other words, when a tough guy likes Oguri Shun in Hazanazakari no Kimitachie. See above. Randomly gets drunk on fermented pickles and suddenly ends up kissing all his guy friends. Oh wow, I've experienced Gatmoe. So girls find that shit cute. If you hit the jump and can check out a list based on a survey of what actions from both sexes cause the Gatmoe feeling. Looking at the men's list, I admit that I am a total sucker for the cool, tough guy with the whimsical smile, the tears, and the sweet desserts guy. There is so much more appealing to me than actual Moe when I find boring and kind of predictive. This is it, Japanator. I found the version of Moe that speaks to me. I feel liberated. Okay, this is going to be interesting and unusually educational, so let's get on to Moe. And hopefully figure out how to woo girls. Okay, according to women, Gatmoe feeling is caused by a cool guy with a whimsical smile. I don't even know what the fuck whimsical means. I'm using Internet Explorer, I know. A playfully quaint or fanciful, especially in an appealing and amusing way, acting or behaving in a capricious manner. Excitable, impulsive. Well, smiling works, I guess. I'm not too fond of smiling, but when a guy who seems to play the field earnestly discusses relationship issues. I don't play the field anymore. Glasses on a guy who usually wears contact lenses. Well, my vision's near perfect, even with the amount of computer games I play. Emoji in an email from a cool guy. Well, I'm not cool. A dandy who likes sweet desserts. I like a tough guy's trembling voice. Trembling voice? A cool guy's tears. This is the gayest shit I've ever read in my life. Ladies, the fuck. An unreliable guy's abrupt decision. Yeah, a little confidence helps. A country accent in a guy who looks like a city kid. A thin guy stuffing his face. Japan, you're weird. What women's act- Whoop! Fuck, I almost spilled that shit. Sorry, haven't slept enough. What women actions cause a Gatmoe feeling? A girl who usually wears trousers in a skirt. Glasses on a girl who usually wears contact lenses. What the fuck is this shit with contact lenses? A cool and tough girl with a whimsical smile. Seriously, guys, the fuck? When a girl who seems to play the field earnestly discusses relationship. A cool girl's tears. And a- Can I ask what the fuck this sample was? Did you give him to pick out of this 10 list? Because this 10 list is shit. Fuck it, I'm not even reading the rest. So Gatmoe has a lot to do with tsundere characters, right? Fuck it. This is shit, I learned nothing. Is this what Gatmoe is supposed to be like? For someone normally so quiet to wear such a daring swimsuit, it makes you a little excited, right, Hajime? You can say that. As long as Hajime doesn't lose his shit, you'll come off as cool and you'll come off as a pervert. Digging your own hole here, buddy. Well, I don't know. Careful with what you're saying, Hajime. That's what I said, but my heartbeat was actually getting faster and faster. And you know what happens when your heartbeat gets faster? You get more blood flow. What happens when you get more blood flow? Seriously, man, never expected Chiaki to have such huge jugs. Soda? Dude.
What happened?
Jugs. Okay, I see what you're talking about, but... Chiaki, why are you just standing there like that in front of me with those things? Wait. Why is the left bra slightly higher than the right one? Is that a push-up bra? It looks like a push-up bra, because it's got the support there to push it up. So it's kind of pushing it up in there, but why are they not equal? Is it that your breasts are not... Okay, stop analyzing. Bad boy. Don't do that.
Hey!
I didn't say that just now. It was Hajime. He's a pervert, you know. Soda, if you want me to throw you under the bus, I will not only throw you under the bus, but I'll make sure that the bus is moving and it's going to drag you down the road for 10 kilometers to the desert. What are you saying? I mean, I only have eyes for Miss Sonya. I've dreamed of going out with a blonde lady ever since I was a kid. You mean to tell me you're telling all these girls here that the only reason you like Sonya is because she's blonde? You're not helping your situation! She's almost blonde. The size is a little small, but this was the only swimsuit that fit me.
Hey.
I don't look good in it? Don't go over the top with a compliment. Just say you look fine. Huh? Well, no, I guess you look good.
Thanks.
Then I'm glad, I guess. Son of a bitch. Wearing a bikini is sure daring, and you get bonus points for wearing a white one. Okay, Buki, settle down. My heart's not just thumping, it's thumping all sporadically like da-dum, thum, thum, da-dum. I'm surprised Monokuma hasn't come out and said something inappropriate. It's probably a heart attack. Fuck it, that's a way to go. I gladly go out with a heart attack at old age after seeing boobs. Like, if I'm gonna go out, I'm gonna go out with style.
Yo!
Hey, kept you waiting. We heard a voice as the diner's door slowly opened, and the person who walked through it was the girl that eats and enjoys to fight. Called it!
Hey!
Sorry to keep you guys waiting.
Keep you guys waiting.
Oh yeah, you read your own line, but isn't that blood?
Akane! What happened to you?
What? Is something wrong? I made sure to wear a swimsuit this time.
Okay, it's not grandpa.
It wouldn't be strange if we nicknamed you Carrie right now.
I don't get the reference.
You're talking about these. On my way over here, I happened to run into Coach Nekomaru.
Oh, come on, don't tell me he beat you over the head.
And when that happens, I gotta fight him, you know?
But why are you bleeding? Wait. Is that his blood or yours? Why does she have to do that?
Are you really all right? Your head, it looks like it's... split in half.
Okay, Nekomura, remember that thing I said about using equal force or just 10% more than their strength? Bashing their skull does not go into that equation.
Well, it'll heal as long as I rub some spit in it, right?
No, don't do that.
You're totally playing up the power of human spit!
Oh, for the love of Christ.
I'm all fired up now. I never knew such a strong opponent even existed.
There's always someone stronger, Akane. Anyway, you need to be treated, and you also need your wounds sterilized. Akane, please come with me. With an unusually forceful demeanor, Mikan pulled Akane into the bathroom. That's why she's the ultimate nurse. Well, it's gonna be okay if we leave it to her. What is this, all this ruckus?
All right!
Oh, who is it this time? Was this premeditated? Does this have something to do with our dating choices earlier in the game? I doubt it does, because all the girls are stripping up in the bikinis, but it's quite literally turning into one of those competitions. Hajime, remember what Confucius said. He who chases two rabbits catches none.
Hajime, Kazuichi, why are you two here?
We are eating burgers. Why are you here?
Hey, aren't you breathing pretty heavily?
I just did a little swimming.
A little swimming?
I swam around the island for about 3 hours.
Holy mother of God.
That's too obvious for me not to comment on. That's definitely not a little swimming.
Why were you already swimming? You guys are about to swim now, right? Isn't that why you're all meeting up?
It wasn't for my enjoyment. I was trying to see if I could swim to a different island.
Huh?
But I couldn't find any other islands. It seems it may be difficult to leave this island by swimming.
Okay, she didn't pick up on the creepiness vibe. Good.
If you didn't see anything after you swam for 3 hours, it's more than difficult. It's impossible.
Yeah, that may be true.
Please don't bring up soda. Please don't bring up soda.
Hey.
Hey, Hajime. Do not say something inappropriate, and do not say it loudly. What?
Awesome!
A woman with wet, slick, black hair is pretty fine too, huh? Yeah. Sure is.
Oh my my!
And this body too, man. God damn it, Ibuki, do not provoke him further. Really? Again?
Young ladies are sure well endowed nowadays. Is that a challenge against all the women in the world?
I guess so.
Fine. Ibuki accepts that challenge with the power of technology. Time to pump these puppies full of silicone!
You do know you can just go to Japan and they'll take fat cells from other parts of your body and put them into your boobs, right? And unlike silicone, it's not gonna appear fake. It's probably a lot healthier.
Don't say such asinine things.
Well, it looks like everyone is almost here, and it's already past 4 p.m. By the way, if you feel a little bit... well, what's the word? That's not what I'm looking for. Sorry, my head's not working. I can't think of anything. When I'm sleep deprived, I can't think of anything new. I can only go on what I already thought up before. If you're feeling a little bit self-conscious about your body, sometimes surgery is not the way to go. Because even if you get surgery, that's not really going to help your self-esteem too much. It's a placebo. Not really a placebo, but more of a band-aid. You gotta learn to love yourselves first. If someone else doesn't love you the way you are, well, fuck them. Of course, I'm not saying don't improve yourself. I'm saying don't use surgery to improve yourself. Improve yourself in other ways. I don't know, put a new mind. Try a new fitness program. Something like that. Stuff yields pretty good results. If a guy's like, ooh, I don't like you because your boob size is this or this or that. Well, then you kind of certainly know what that guy's in for, don't you? I mean, sure, if you want them for yourself, cool. But if you want them for someone else, you're doing it for the wrong reasons. Do things for yourself, not other people. And so, all that's left is...
I am terribly sorry for my delay.
Here we go. Here comes the princess. Way to play it cool. He's doubled down on excitement. Alright, what kind of sexy swimsuit is Miss Sonya wearing? That. Use your imagination, my friend. It's not always about skin. Sometimes it's about class.
It is to prevent sunburn. I do not want my skin to be sun damaged.
Gracious of you.
However, as I have never worn a wetsuit before, I had a hard time putting it on, which resulted in my delay.
I'll be more than happy to help you next time.
Really? It is my bad.
Oh, no, no, no. It's perfectly fine. Oh, what the fuck am I saying? I see. A wetsuit. Well, Miss Sonya does have beautiful white skin. Fucking racist.
Miss Sonya!
But that tight outfit of hers is amazing. Just what I'd expect from a 100% purebred princess. creepiness vibe is just through the roof. Purebred? This guy is quick to recover. Recover? Shit, he digs so deep even I don't know how deep it is. Anyway, why are you two here? You know what? Say whatever the fuck you want. I'll answer that, Miss Sonya. Oh, for the love of God. I'll be honest. If you're gonna go to the beach, please let us come with you. Going by your previous excuses, that is a lot less creepy. Because you could at least say you found out from the other girls that you just met like 10 minutes ago.
I am concerned.
Well, this was originally supposed to be a girls only outing to strengthen our friendship with each other. Do you think you can make an exception? Pretty please? Well, it's okay. It's not like there'd be any problems, even if there are some boys.
Then...
You're right. They came all the way here. It would be bad if we made them leave. Ah, Miss Sonya is so kind. You're such a sucker for aristocrats, aren't you?
Alright!
Alright, now that it's decided, let's get going. But Akane's wounds are still being treated.
Shut up! Shut up!
Shut up, there's no way I can just stand around. I'll go on ahead and prepare. Sure. That attitude is gonna get you so far in life. I'll set up the parasol and prepare the drinks.
Engine's revving!
I mean it. I promise I'll give it my all to serve you so everyone has fun. Serve? Okay, whatever. With an abnormal amount of gusto, he bolted out of the diner. Just keep walking in front of us like that. We've sort of noticed. I'm kind of indifferent to it by now. I'm surrounded by girls in swimsuits. This is a little awkward. Only if you let it be, my friend. Only if you let it be. I should go help Kazuichi too. You didn't even offer them a drink. You didn't even offer them food. How disappointing. As I mumbled my excuse, I ran out of diner, almost as if I were escaping. I am disappointed. I am so disappointed. Let's get back in there. It's a little embarrassing to go back inside. I should chase after Kazuichi and head toward the beach. Yep. Fight or flight, you chose to flight. Pussy. And if I find a body, I'm gonna be pissed. Ah, fuck. Huh? That bell just now. Could it be?
A body has been discovered! Now then, after a certain amount of time has passed, the class trial will begin!
So Kazuichi was the third person to see the body. The little crying girl was obviously the second. And the first was the killer. And the redhead, whose name I can't remember, is probably dead. And cue the music. That's a lie. Impossible.
Someone.
Someone come here!
Ugh. That was definitely Kazuichi's voice just now. It sounds like he's nearby. Great. And we got a body inside. If I'm right. No way. Am I being nervous about? There's no reason for me to be nervous. Body discovery announcement? Yeah, I won't believe it! I'm not going to believe it. There's no way I'll believe it. Who would believe something like that? As I raised my voice, I swiftly stepped inside the beach house. I won't believe it. The moment I stepped inside the beach house and cue the music. Oh, those words mercilessly shattered into pieces. Music! The bat. Why is she dead the same way as the game? If this was all a dream, when did I begin dreaming? if this is reality. Why is Mahiro on the floor covered in blood? I couldn't understand anything that was in front of me. And I couldn't believe in anything. Sea and punishment, sin and coconuts. And I just have a chill down my spine. Masahiro Koizumi, the ultimate photographer. She had an unyielding force of personality, but she was actually very good at taking care of people. And she was always straightforward, toward us and toward herself. She was always facing forward. She was that kind of person. Why her? Why Mahiru? Why? Why did this happen to her? And why do you have that fucking grin on your face? The muscles in my face stiffened and grew hard. Darkness clouded my vision. My legs started to wobble and I instinctively placed my hands against the wall.
Damn it!
Hey, Hajime? Before this, we were having a great time, right? Sure we were, buddy. Sure we were. We were excited about going to the beach. We were having lots of fun. But why?
Are you kidding me?
Why did something like this happen? Someone tell me. I obviously don't know what's going on either.
Oh.
Huh? comic relief. Now that's not the time to make bubbles. Hurry and get the others. Ibuki instantly left the beach house. I'm sure it took some time for everyone else to come here. They had to change and whatnot. It must have taken some time. So there's a body announcement, and they take the time to change. Why? But I didn't really know how much time had passed. My senses were numbed. My emotions were also numbed. Within me, various layers were peeling off. My senses started to return around the time I realized that others were already here.
Huh?
What the hell is this? Why, Mahiru? The girls were standing outside the door leading to the beach, their faces pale with terror.
Something like this!
For heaven's sake, what in the world is going on? With their pale faces still intact, the girls began wobbling toward the beach house, until a voice stopped them.
Hold it.
Hold on a sec.
Hmm.
Those things beneath you, be careful not to step on them.
What?
Beneath?
See?
You know the footprints in front of that door? These are footprints leading out of the beach house, right? That's probably an important clue. So don't step on them.
Huh?
If you mean evidence, Monokuma mentioned it in the announcement. Right after a certain amount of time, we'll hold a class trial.
What the?
Another class trial?
Are you serious?
Then are you saying this is...
That's right!
That's right! One of you guys killed her.
Lies!
Killed? That's impossible.
Hey, hey!
It's not like an accident or something?
Like...
If you think that's an accident, that still means this death was caused by someone else's actions, right?
In other words...
That also counts as a legitimate murder. That's for the courts to decide. Though such deaths fall into a grey area, on this island I will make sure it's clear to you guys. On this island, dying from sickness is basically only death that's not considered a murder. Well, it's impossible to get sick and die on this island, not when Monomi takes such good care of people. Oh wow, you're taunting her.
What's this?
Oh, speaking of which...
I don't like this!
There it is, the silent treatment attack. This is like the number one thing that hurts me. Well fine, I'm not gonna lose to your bashing. I've decided to become a tough kid. This is the worst, once again, this horrible nightmare. Another victim, and it's all because of Monokuma.
No way!
Jeez, it's not my fault. Huh? Then whose fault is it, you ask?
Yahoo!
To find out, we hold a class trial.
So
let's begin already. No whining, just begin already.
It's the Monokuma file!
Okay, I shall pass out the Monokuma file number 2. This should start to feel familiar.
Do your best.
Now then, do your very best to investigate. I'll see you later at the class trial. Class trial. Investigation. This is horrible. It's just too horrible.
Hey!
Then you should have stopped the murder before it occurred. Don't you have that kind of power? That... I did have that power before he appeared.
Perhaps.
Even if she tries to stop it, judging from Monokuma and Monomi's relationship, there's no doubt she'd get stopped herself. Yes, Monokuma took everything away, including the magic stick, and the surveillance cameras. The only thing I can rely on are those ears, but they can only hear about 3 times that of a normal person.
So basically,
I have no idea what's happening on this island in the first place. I'm just the worst. A powerless rabbit like me is the worst. Now's not the time to focus on something like that. More importantly, what should we do? Do we have to do it again? That cruel thing, we have to do it again?
Why?
I cannot believe it. Mahito was killed by one of us.
Damn it!
Yeah, I can't do this anymore. Investigating the class trial, seriously, I'm done. Everyone feels the same, but we can't do anything else except do it. And there's no way we could just ignore the reason Mahito was killed.
Hey.
Yeah, the only thing we can do is investigate.
Because it's bad.
Because we should never forget that. Killing is something we should never forget. Chiaki.
Well?
The killer has their reasons. I understand that. It was the same for Teru too. It's really all Monokuma's fault. I understand that too. But even so, we should never forgive killing.
Allow it.
She usually has her head in the clouds, so for her to say something like that, she probably can't forgive this at all. But that's true of me too.
Understood.
Regardless, everyone is going to die if we don't do it. In order for us all to survive, we must do it.
I'm gonna do it!
Then let's do this!
Perhaps.
Mahito probably wants us to do this too. She would want us to reveal the truth behind the death. I understand. If everyone's doing it, I will do it too, but please give me a little time. Please give me a little time to calm myself a little. Also, I will go and tell the others who aren't here about this. You're right, if all you heard was that announcement, you won't know where the murder took place. I shall excuse myself for now. Then let's begin. We need to round up everyone so evidence is not hidden. Oh wait, littering can't happen. Wait, then what's that mask? Isn't that mask littering? Who killed Mahito Koizumi? Why was she killed? We gotta find out and solve this already. That's right, we have to do it again. It's the only way. I don't want to do this, but that's more the reason for us to finish this. I'm the only one who can do this. And so it begins. First, I need to take a look at the Monokuma file. Dead. The victim is Mahito Koizumi. Estimated time of death is around 3 p.m. The scene of the crime where the body was discovered is inside the beach house and the Chandelier Beach. The cause of death is a single blow to the head with a blunt instrument. There are no other conspicuous external injuries and no trace of foreign substances as drugs. Around 3 p.m, that's the time Kazuichi and I arrived at the diner. And if we had just gone to the beach house instead. No, now's not the time to feel regret. I need to focus on doing as much as I can right now. And then I'm gonna find out the truth behind Mahito's death. That's the only way the rest of us can survive. Truth bullet has been added to your section. Well, guys. Save the game. We are going to continue with this investigation next time because I spent, well, to be honest, about 6 hours playing. So I need to go get some sleep because the sun just rose, as you see, and I haven't really slept. So I'm going to take a little sleep and then I'm going to binge some more Danganronpa 2 because I really want to get to the anime. I really, 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 really want to get to the anime. So if you haven't already, be sure to like the video. It really does help. Give me your favorite bits in the comment section below with timestamps and be sure to check out the next episode as soon as it comes out. Till next time, Ninjakuma out. Bye! Okay, she's got a pretty cool song. This game is so weird!